What's up, dude?
Nice to see you again.
Nick is not green is here.
That chair. Yeah.
Dude, your shoes are fire. Those are some sick ass shoes.
Yeah, it's true.
They're sick.
And it was the only size they had and it fit. Okay.
Okay, folks. You already know what time it is, okay? Well, first of all, it's the top of the hour ad break, which is, you know, what you're going to be watching right now, unless you subscribe for $5 or for free with a Twitch Prime. Hand knit suit, thank you for the 20 gifted subs, allowing 20 people to no longer see the ads at the top of the hour. Nick is not green is here. We are going to, as you can tell, he's a Zoomer.
Yeah, you can tell I'm a Zoomer.
Yeah.
Some people think I'm Gen Alpha. Is Gen Alpha?
That's like, I don't even know what the age group you're in if you're Gen Alpha, honestly.
You have to be like less than 8, 12 or something.
Yeah, speak super close into the mic and like
Hello.
Be loud.
Hello.
Yeah, you're that way you're good.
Okay.
Gen Alpha is what? 2010 plus, 12 and younger?
2010 plus. Okay.
Feast on his blood to gain his youth. That's actually why I brought him here. I'm going to do like that finance bro guy. I'm going to do, he's my blood boy. Nick is my new blood boy.
You had an old.
Yeah. Blood like boy. As a, like I had another blood boy. You know, we don't talk about what happened to him. So Nick is the new blood boy.
Thank you.
Now,
I'm very.
Infinite Ryman. Thank you for the tank of the substitution. 3 minute ad break now, by the way, before I forget. Generation Alpha is 2010 to 2023, so the oldest is 13 years old, and you were born when?
1999.
You were born in 19... Oh, my God. You didn't make the cutoff. You're not a 2000 baby.
No, I'm a 90s kid, guys. I'm a full-blown 90s kid.
So you're not... You're like a fake Zoomer, dude. You barely...
Yeah, no, I'm kind of a fake Zoomer. I'm also kind of a fake... I'm like a fake drama person, because I don't actually... Normally, I don't even use TikTok, actually. I just started, like, getting things from people. But then yesterday, I was just, like, all over the drama. I was on top.
Yeah. Okay. You say you're not, like, a TikTok drama guy.
It's
but
like
let's,
my last. Well, I was.
Let's look at this. Let's look at this real quick.
The second channel.
It's not on the first one? No. What the second channel?
It's going to pass the first one, I think, at some point.
Okay, let's take a look. So this is you're not a TikTok drama guy, you say. Fine, no. I'll talk about the Tattoo Gate drama.
Until.
Country fans are losing their minds over Morgan Wallen. The Cake Gate, the TikTok drama goes deeper than you think. This TikTok drama went too far.
Yeah. Okay, listen. I wasn't TikTok drama curator, but then...
the algorithm forced you into it.
Yeah, they gave me a lot of money for it, so...
Yeah.
I'm still doing it, and it's fun. Okay.
Yeah. So because you're the TikTok, you're the TikTok correspondent. This is Nick Talk.
Yeah, I have a lot of. Yesterday, I spent like a lot of hours going down, like all these different rabbit holes.
Uh huh.
So I have like this loose interpretation of drama. I DM'd you a link, a Google.
Yeah, I have it right here. I'm gonna pull it up.
So I have like. A lot of various things, and I'm thinking we just sort of weave in and out of them.
Okay, what's happening in the world of TikTok? I rarely ever go on TikTok, but from what I understand, is this link like if they see it, they'll be able to edit it, right?
This public,
it says
actually maybe they would.
Yeah, it says edit on it, so I don't think I should show them that.
Oh,
hold on, I'll figure it out.
Export it as a PDF. Wait, let me see if I can.
I'll hide it. Or wait, why don't I just like copy and paste it and put it on my own Google Drive.
Private link.
Yeah.
I brought a lot of random various stories, but there's like a few that I'm very excited to share with everybody.
Wait, oh no, that didn't do anything. That didn't change anything. Let's see. There's so much activity going on there. Just don't mention anything that's happening out there. Just, you know.
Have you been keeping up with the...
What?
Taylor Swift, Maddie Healy...
Have I been keeping up with it? Yes. So, first and foremost, let me just start off by stating that, like, do I think it's incredibly funny? Abso-fucking-lutely. Because the entire reason why this even became a thing, which even led to, like, Taylor Swift collaborating with Ice Spice.
And she showed up to her, like, show in New Jersey. Like, performed in front of this whole stadium and everything. And they're, like, hugging and all this stuff.
Yeah. And all of this happened because of fucking, you know, Cumtown slash the Adam Friedland show. So, yeah, I do find that particularly fun. I find that hilarious, as a matter of fact. Wait, why? Yeah. Okay, it doesn't seem like it's showing the Google link.
Well, okay.
Nope, never mind. It showed it again. I don't know how to hide it.
That's your Google link, which is private, I think.
No, it's not. It still says edit on it. I don't know how to fucking change that.
Who cares? Guys, please don't.
Yeah, no, definitely.
Well, we have a copy anyway, so if someone with us, we'll fuck right back.
He's so old. Export as PDF? No, because then can PDFs have clickable links on them?
You might be able to if Google Chrome is like your God.
I don't know how to do any of this. God damn it!
Print to PDF. Or destination. Save as PDF. Yeah. Now I'm teaching you how to do. I feel like you're just a senior citizen, and I'm like,
well, this is important.
Get exported to PDF, and then we'll talk about the TikTok drama.
Yeah. This is how do I download computer PDF? Okay. Hold on. Let's turn this off. It's hard, man. It's not fucking easy, chat. Fuck you guys.
No, there's a lot of clicking and minimizing and shit that goes with this stuff, guys.
Okay, here it is. There it is. And then we'll have the PDF open over here.
Okay.
Okay, so what are you going to hit us with first and foremost? You got...
Okay. I'm going to do... Let's start with early drama, just because I feel like this one would be funny. If you scroll down to where to the next link where it says book talk lady apologizes. Now this was like a month ago, but I want to show it because it's got a few crazy steps. But first, basically what happened is she put out this TikTok.
I'm sure I'm going to get in trouble for
Wait.
It's now deleted.
Oh, I know this one. But dude, I already know this. I already know this. This TikTok drama ain't shit to me, dude.
I know, but you have to watch. You have to follow the
This one is the first one, right?
So this is the original one.
Do not do this stitch incoming. What the fuck? Okay. What happened here?
Yeah, this is a disaster. But the original TikTok is this woman saying...
the artificial intelligence ways that you can use AI to like get writing notes for yourself to like become a famous published author. Yeah,
to have like objective criticism on your writing.
Yeah, it was the worst video I've ever seen of all time. For every other reason, but there was also like one specific reason why it was really bad because like the book that she was recommending as her like GOAT. Her best book ever was what was it like the Hank Green novel?
Oh, or John Green?
Or John Green novel, sorry.
Fault in Our Stars?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, really?
That was like her OG. Dude, am I teaching you the TikTok?
I know, I'm like, what yo, the this fuck? Is really interesting. Wait, but this goes deeper because we can show people like the first couple sections of the stitch, you kind of get an idea of what it is. But basically, she tells people to put their writing into ChatGPT. All the writers get angry, stitch it. And then she puts out this apology where you'd think that, like, she killed somebody or said, like, a slur or, like, did something very, like, unforgivable.
I'm sure the TikTokers that fucking responded to her were literally, like, out for blood. They were like, what the fuck? Which I get it. Everyone is very sensitive on the internet, especially on, like, especially when it comes to the arts. Does Chad have the OG video? I have the CIA in here.
Yeah,
it's so they could potentially pull this real quick if they wanted to, I suspect.
Yeah.
Just turn this off. Let me do that.
Yeah, if we don't get the main one, we'll go.
Does anybody in here have it?
Come on, guys.
I'm sure you can find it.
It's probably somewhere on Twitter, yeah.
It is on Twitter. I remember, like... I remember, but I don't know how to like find it. You know what I mean?
Maybe
Honey, you can bring her in here. Did she pee and poop? Okay, come in here, Kaya. This is my puppy, yeah. No, it's fine. Let him chill outside. We'll bring him in a little bit.
The other dog.
Someone find it already? Oh, yi, yi, dude. Why are you like this? Why are you like... Take a week off, actually. Fuck not. Fuck that. I'm not even going to give you a day off.
Yeah, block that.
I hate when we're like looking for something, and it's content for you, and then you literally turn around and you poop sock it. No, it's not on TikTok. I think she deleted it.
Apologize about it.
No, oh, yeah, this is the apology.
No, this apology.
We want the original one, which like banged on Twitter. Like I remember watching it on Twitter. Oh, here it
is. Whether your writing is good enough to be published, I have the ultimate writing hack for you.
First of all, can we just talk about the cadence? Because there is like a TikTok cadence.
Yeah,
you're like, a TikTok expert.
What I'm talking about.
Yeah, everyone always is like so deliberate with their language.
It's so annoying. You'll see it a lot today.
Bonus points if they like have a side profile that they figured out is like the best. Yeah, the best way that their face looks, I guess, where they're like, "What's up? What's going on?" And this has it all, really. Deliberate, like she's very deliberate. Her cadence is like the TikTok cadence. It's the Zoomer transatlantic accent. Yes, exactly.
Whoa, I've never seen it explained that way.
Yeah, well, millennials do it too.
That's crazy.
I'm sure I'm going to get in trouble for sharing this. Did you know you can use ChatGPT to get a legitimately objective assessment of your writing? One of the top mistakes that writers make is querying agents or self-publishing their work before it is really ready.
Bad
I get that.
Idea.
I've been there. And our writer friends love us too much to be as brutally honest as we need them to be. But you know who can be brutally honest? A robot. I'm going to feed the first page for my...
She's like so like, I'm fucking this up right
Did anyone ever think about this idea?
Kaya, stop it. Such a... She's a cutie pie. Yeah, she smells terrible, but, you know, it's okay because she's a little pupper.
But yeah, today's theme, at least for me, happened to be like apologies. Like there's a lot of apologies we're gonna watch today. This one is not the funniest apology, but it's a good one to get us into it.
It's a funny story because like it's so silly and it's so dumb. And yeah, this is the offending. This is how this entire saga
you know
began.
Who can be brutally honest? A robot. I'm going to feed the first page for my upcoming novel into ChatGPT right now to see if it's good enough. I'm actually pretty nervous. This book is coming out in June and I might find out it sucks. To calibrate, I'm first going to ask ChatGPT to rank one of the best books of all time.
One of the best books of all
time. We will be rating for 6 factors. Let's see how John did. Not bad.
One of the best books of all time is what she said.
Let's see how John did. 8.
To calibrate on the other end, I put in some garbage writing. Okay, no surprise there. Moment of truth, time to put my ass on the grill. All right, not too bad. Let me know in the...
So, like, does this mean that she like, actually owned a little bit? Like, she owned John Green a little bit. Like,
I mean, at least in... what did she get a 9 on? Dialogue?
Yeah, writing style, John Green gets a 9.
Her dialogue's better than...
Yeah. Her dialogue is better, and everything else is, like, close enough to The Fault in Our Stars. So she has a banger in her hands, I think.
Yeah, this is huge for her.
Yeah.
So then this is, like, whatever. I was like, this is just going to be some... People get annoyed, whatever. But then the apology for this is, like, so intense that I was just like, did I miss, like, part of this? Which I didn't. This is it, but...
No, this is the offender. This is the offensive.
Right, not too bad. Let me know in the comments.
You have to play
ranks.
This apology. It's crazy.
So, well, let's just go straight into the apology, right? Before the stitched version?
Yeah, there was basically... The stitched version was just to watch, like...
Oh, okay. So, this is the apology that came... Wait, really? This only has, like, 900
yeah, no,
likes?
No, I know. She wasn't a TikToker before this. But she had to deliver... This is a big theme of today. Having to deliver an apology as a regular person who got canceled in
okay.
the real world.
I want to apologize about a video I posted a few days ago telling writers you could use ChatGPT to get feedback on the first page of your manuscript. I didn't know the extent to how ChatGPT uses the data that you give it when I posted that video, which was incredibly irresponsible of me. And I really regret posting it.
It's like, what is going on? Like,
what the fuck? Yo, what happened? So, like, did ChatGPT kill someone and I'm missing? Like, what? Like, it's bad, yes, but, like, not this bad. What the fuck? I mean, she's just cringe. A lot of times what I've found, especially from my own personal experience of being, like, the main character on Twitter, which, by the way, shouts out to Elon Musk. I realized that, like, after he took over Twitter and the trending bar has been, like, broken, I have, like, that has led to a noticeable decrease in cancellations for me.
Honestly, that makes sense.
Yeah, he broke the trending tab, and now I don't get canceled.
He used to always be on my trending tab.
Yeah, it's so sick. No, it's fucking awesome, dude.
And you're a blue check, so it's like best of both worlds. You know, you get to be on the top of the...
That part he really fucked up for everyone. The replies are awful always, but basically... Yes, as this chatter points out, TikTok takes something really cringe and turns it into genocide.
Oh, yeah.
And then, ironically, their reaction is, like, sometimes death and murder and doxing, yeah, really which is why it's, like, no, that's, like, way worse than just, like, being cringe on main. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Anyway, let's continue.
I've since dived into ChatGPT's privacy policy and terms of use, and it's some scary stuff. Because it's so new, we don't know how things like plagiarism or copyright are going to be handled. Which means if you give it your intellectual property, it could then spit it out to someone else who could claim copyright over your work, or maybe even sue you for plagiarizing your own writing.
Which also, is that ever going to happen? Like, do you think it'll get to the point where...
Maybe. I mean, there's patent trolls, dude. People are fucking really aggressive with, like, copyright and, like, you know...
Yeah.
And enforcing copyright violations that are, like, super questionable. So, if there's a way to make money, I can totally see motherfuckers, like, assholes trying to make money.
Yeah, because the idea to her, at least, is that, like, you feed your writing into this... then ChatGPT technically has your copyrighted work and it can, like, spit it out to someone else. And I don't think they're ever, like, I don't think there's, like, a realistic situation where ChatGPT just, like, spits out, like, someone's, like, entire book and then they get stolen. But, like, I mean, obviously it's still, like, you're still plugging your shit into something that no one knows anything about.
You can't copyright things generated by AI. I mean, I don't know. I don't know what the language or the law around it is.
I don't know either.
Supposedly ChatGPT does not incorporate user inputs right now. That could change. But again, it doesn't really, like, I mean, nothing that she suggested was anything beyond just, like, extremely cringe.
Yeah, it's just like a glorified, like, plagiarism checker. Not, well, whatever the grammar.
Well, even plagiarism checking on ChatGPT has actually led to a lot of issues.
Really?
You never saw this one? A professor, well, this wasn't TikTok drama, but a professor put all of his students' essays through ChatGPT to see if they, like, were plagiarized by ChatGPT and gave everybody Fs when, like, no one had actually used ChatGPT, but ChatGPT lies all the fucking time.
It was like, yeah, of course we've seen this.
Yeah, ChatGPT literally lies to you, and a lot of people don't understand that. Like, they think it's, like, super accurate. Like, everything you get from ChatGPT is, like, 100% accurate. It's like, no, it basically tells you what you want to hear in a lot of instances.
Yeah, this is... But she should legitimately go to jail for this.
Yeah, no, I agree.
It's been a rough 24 hours. I started posting the other week, hoping to provide some writing tips and to make writers feel less alone. I never meant to cause writers any harm with my video. And I really apologize. I'm going to take the next few days to really think more deeply about how and
what the fuck.
Just regular civilians have to.
The, like, only thing that would have made this better if she started off with a land acknowledgement. I think that's, like, that's what makes most things better, in my opinion, in my experience.
Yeah.
This is so good. Right, God, I love liberalism. It makes so much content.
I'm going to go spend some time outside now.
So that's the video. Does this Stitch have, like, actual responses to her?
Yeah, people, a ton of people stitched this. It was just authors being like, actually, no, and you should die.
Let's see.
And it also shows that, like, every author, like, talks on TikTok the same exact way.
Yeah, 100%. None of you are writing books. No one is reading your books. If you're an author on TikTok, good luck.
Or just type in Lauren K. writes her thing into TikTok, and you'll get all of, like, the top responses.
Well, I want to see this one first.
Did you know you can use ChatGPT to get a legitimate...
Authors, don't do this. Do not put your writing into ChatGPT. It basically will lift your writing to use for other people's work. Don't do this. It's the same.
She got the author glasses, though. I'll tell you that. That's like,
yeah, that's huge.
You know, this is, you're about to read the sexiest YA novel.
Yeah.
Way it steals artistic AI. Please don't put your writing.
Okay. So let's see. Lauren K. writes, you said?
Oh, yeah. We'll find the ones with, are like way too excited to dunk on her.
Not a lot of views on any of the dunks on this one, though. What's happening? Niche. Why is it not showing up? I thought this was like a bigger deal. Maybe it was like a bigger deal on Twitter, because I know Twitter. So that's the other component of TikTok, is like TikTok and Twitter together is the explosive combination that creates this like manufactured cycle, this drama cycle that like keeps everybody entertained for a brief moment. And oftentimes, the people that you leave behind are just like brain broken from the experience of being like doxxed and ritualistically humiliated by millions of people, even though they were just like a normal person before they put that out there.
Yeah, but then this is like the triple slammy is this link right here, insane video. This is what made me be like, okay, now. And the rain starts.
Wait, what is this?
Just, it has nothing to do with the situation.
Oh, she apologized, and then this is how she came out with, like, after this? What?
Every photo is Jimmy Fallon. How does she have that many photos of Jimmy Fallon?
I don't understand. Was she dating Jimmy Fallon? Like, what?
So the song, the lyrics of the song are basically saying, like, I had crushes on the boys who were on the TV when I was, like, in high school and this and that. But the guy she's talking about is Jimmy Fallon, and she has, like, dozens of photos she took with him when she was in high school, which I later learned was because she would, every weekend, her and her friends would do standby at SNL, so they'd, like, wait to see SNL as extra seats to, like, let them in. And so she took, like, she was obsessed with Jimmy Fallon. And I learned that she, and then she calls them fictional boyfriends are greater than IRL. And I'm like,
she's a young adult romance novelist. She's a YA novelist.
Jimmy Fallon is like the dream man for every YA novelist.
This is not a bit. SNL fangirls have been wild for years. I remember mid-20s, 2000s Tumblr.
Oh, there's a couple of other guys spend here. It's like 90% Jimmy Fallon.
Mostly Jimmy Fallon.
Fred Armisen. Jim Carrey, I think.
I don't know.
And of course, Jimmy Fallon at the end again.
Okay. They should have canceled her for that instead of the other thing.
I don't said anything about the Jimmy
Fallon. All
right, Fallon.
Well, you want to move on to another celebrity?
Yes, I want to. This one's interesting. This one's a fun one.
Okay, this is the trigger warning, okay?
You know about this one, obviously.
Trigger warning, guys. This is, I know about this drama. I didn't cover it, but I honestly, I should have. This is huge, okay? This is very big. Jenna Ortega.
This is really bad.
Guys, trigger warning. Jenna Ortega smoking a cigarette.
You remember the comment where it's the guy being like, please be weed, please be weed.
I did not see that. Wait, I didn't actually look at any of the responses, but wait, hold on. Let's not jump the gun here. Let's watch this video, okay? I need you
I don't
to
know
see.
If I can.
I need you to see this in all of its glory, okay? That's right. Oh God. Oh no.
Oh no.
Oh no. It's over. It's Jover. She's smoking a cigarette, guys. It's done. It's so bad. Twitter received this in the most normal Twitter way possible, where like you had people in the stand-up going, I hope that's not a cigarette. I'm freaking out. Where is it? Is this the one?
It's the...
This guy?
No, this one is this guy who is just obsessed with the fact. He's like under so many replies, and it's crazy, but...
Hold on. Show me the
original one's the one at the main tweet at the bottom. This crybaby one.
Okay. So.
Yeah, this is the one that shows all the.
Okay, so this is garnered hilarious reactions. Wonder where she learned this.
This is her in a movie. So he's saying like, oh, she learned this in a movie. So now she's doing it in real life.
Yeah, that's really fucked up. I can't believe actors are in movies. Please be weed. Please be weed. Is this for a movie or nah? Is that a cigarette? So I think what we don't factor in to consideration, and I like had this moment in my mind recently about like a Twitter account that I sometimes engage with and like read his writings. A lot of people on Twitter, you don't know how old they are.
Oh.
So like there's a very high likelihood that this person is like 12.
They like legitimately don't know what a cigarette looks like.
Or they're just like, oh my God, it's a cigarette. It's the worst thing I've ever seen.
Yeah.
So Twitter is great though, obviously for this kind of thing, because on the one hand you had this, and then on the other hand, people were like jokingly saying cigarettes are cool and sick.
Yeah. And then there's like this huge side of Twitter that's like very anti-cigarette to the point where they think anyone who smokes a cigarette is like,
bad.
It's
a bad person.
We need to kill them.
Yeah. And then even Gen Z hates cigs. Yeah, they're fucking, I don't care about Gen Z's opinion on cigarettes. You want to know why? Because their fucking lungs have collapsed already from inhaling the metric ton of vape juice that is like aftermarket and illegal, okay?
And they can do it during school hours, which they can't do with like a cigarette.
Yeah, exactly.
You're hitting it throughout the day, which is like, you're fucked.
Exactly. So I don't give a fuck about what Zoomers have to say about cigarettes, even though, yeah, don't smoke. But also, at the same time, it does make you look cool, okay? But also, don't smoke. It's the worst thing that you can do, okay? Yeah.
But if you look through the original tweet I showed you, and you go in the responses, because you get all the blue checks first. So, of course, every single response is, like, people who are, like... Smoking full-on cigarettes at 20 years old? It's like,
full-on? Wait, what do you, like, what is that? Instead of, like, a half cigarette? Like, what does that mean?
She also isn't, like chain smoking. She, like, barely inhaled any smoke. And everyone's like, smoking full-on cigarettes at 20?
Yeah, it's fucked up. It's fucked up.
So that part, where's that guy that I linked two of his tweets. This one under it isn't hyperlinked. The Chauncey Gardner, but this tweet's crazy also.
Okay. So I even have a Twitter mutual that actually got involved in this as well, where, here, we'll look at this Chauncey Gardner guy, though. Right. U.S. billionaire Mike Bloomberg is spending $150 million per year to convince the public hashtag safer nicotine vapes are at least as harmful as combustible cigarettes, which kill half of all users. Today, 70% of Americans believe that falsehood. So Jenna smokes. Okay, this guy's a PhD too, which, or I mean, I don't know if he is, but it says he's a PhD on his Twitter account.
So he must be.
And you can't lie. It's illegal to lie on Twitter. So I'm going to believe him. I'm inclined to believe that he truly is a PhD. Let me fix the Kaya cam a little bit. She's being extra cute right now. Okay. So Zara W says, where did the smoke go? She didn't exhale it. Says, yeah, no, you can see it. Look more carefully. You can see the exhale and the side stream smoke coming off the cig itself. But she's not inhaling a massive cloud. Me, she's not inhaling much. But she did inhale.
It's like the whole like virginity construct of like the moment that like this thing happens, then you're suddenly like a cigarette smoker or you're a sex haver.
Yeah,
whatever it is, like the smoke went in and out of your lungs, you're a smoker.
Yeah, well, I don't understand why people are this hyper fixated on it one way or another, but I do like it. I had a friend, I had a Twitter mutual literally posting about like, you know, posting studies about how like it's okay to smoke cigarettes until the age of 30 to 35 as long as you like quit.
Yeah, as long as you just stop doing it.
But as long as you quit before before 35, and then, like, your lungs will go back to the same, health that it was at prior to smoking cigarettes, which is, like, it sounds insane, but it also completely It completely, you know, misses how difficult it is to stop.
Yeah, that's the trick.
Smoking.
It's not to know when to stop.
Yeah.
He's like, you guys are just confused about when you're supposed to stop. You think you're supposed to stop way older. You guys just have to cut it out in your 30s, which is like if you smoked cigarettes before then, that's going to be the hardest time to quit. Like,
it's as someone who used to smoke a pack a day, I'm going to tell you right now, it is the worst, okay? It is literally the absolute fucking worst thing. All jokes aside, I mean, as a drunk driving advocate, as a smoking advocate, I have to also tell you, literally, it is very, very, very shitty for you. I still chew nicotine gum non-fucking stop, so just remember that. Nicotine gum is also a very good way to stop smoking.
And you still drive drunk, too.
Mm-hmm. Well, that one is just like, I just drive better when I'm drunk. That's why. Yeah, so people freaked the fuck out, and Twitter did the thing that Twitter is supposed to do. But I think a lot of this can like be explained with, with just like a lot of people are just either memeing, like using cigarettes as the account, or a lot of people are like 12 and they have no way of understanding. You know, people messing around. They just like think everything is serious.
Wait, is your friend this using cigarettes guy? Like, is he the one that got, you said one of your friends got into.
No, the friend I got. No, my friend was like legitimately arguing to my Twitter mutual, who is a fitness guy and a leftist, you know, an all around good dude, was really invested in telling people that you can. And yeah, Muhammad. I don't think he was memeing. Like, he was posting like studies and shit.
That's great.
What about that Indonesian baby who smoked 36 a day? Is that a real thing? Half the people who are in love with Jenna Ortega are in high school. Me, by the way. Yeah, I think that's probably part of it, right? The Jenna Ortega fandom is like,
it's like literally 17-year-old.
Yeah,
boys.
It's like, I mean, of course. It's like, I watched the Wednesday show because it was like something that I could watch with my mom.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because like, you just got to figure out like, what can you watch with the family? And
I can't like imagine a picture
it was terrible.
Sitting there and watching the Wednesday show with
your mom. It was not good. I will admit. It was not for me.
Apparently she didn't like it either. Have you seen those clips? People are mad at her for that too, because she like,
didn't she say she like rewrote it?
Yeah, she said that like the writers just sucked. Oh my god. Oh, this is him.
They're pleasant sometimes, have been in the center of nice memories for me. I didn't expect people to go insane when I was talking neutrally about them in the half chest. Like, people are fine with so many other equally bad vices like alcohol, but cigs are the soul Satan, apparently. I mean, they are pretty destructive, they're pretty deadly. But you know, he's Iranian. Like, you're being xenophobic if you get mad at an Iranian man for defending smoking cigarettes. That's all I'm gonna say about this. Okay,
off hands.
Yeah, you have to let him argue that you should smoke. Okay, he is an Iranian man.
That's
it's
what
just,
they do.
It's just how it is. It's just how it goes. Jenna Ortega could never.
Oh, I do remember this meme.
I don't. It's not a meme. It's real life.
You know this meme. It's a YouTube video.
This toddler on the island of Sumatra, famous for his nicotine addiction.
Look at how cool he is. That's the coolest.
He does look.
Bro, that is the coolest baby of all time, dude. This is literally an. Why are we? Are we arguing for? Wait, what the fuck? This baby also does heroin.
This is what he's known for.
What the fuck? He's got a leather jacket and everything, dude.
Aldi Rizal started smoking.
He just sit around and watch him do
old.
It.
Now he's hooked and on 40 a day. And don't think of denying him his fix. A toddler goes crazy, screaming, slamming his head on the floor, even getting sick if he doesn't get his 2 packs a day.
I've never seen someone with this small of like hands holding a cigarette and it's just like massive.
Dude, he is the goat.
He's
dude.
Also blowing. He's doing like smoke tricks for them.
Dude, he is so sick. Okay. I'm back to, oh my God, he quit. Nobody likes a quitter, baby. You fucking dumb bitch. Loser. You dumb baby. Imagine quitting cigarettes. What the fuck? You were so sick. Wait, The cigarette-puffing, tricycle-riding Indonesian 2-year-old with a 2-pack-a-day habit has changed his ways and is now a star pupil in his primary school, according to a report. Artie Rizal, who is now 9 years old, became a viral sensation in 2010 when he was captured smoking 40 cigarettes a day while cruising around in the village of Sumatra in a red plastic toy car. Embarrassed Indonesian government officials 2 years later got the child in rehab, where he managed to kick the habit but developed a food addiction.
Oh, my God.
By the age of 5, of course, that's the byproduct of, like, not... Also, yeah, I was going to say, he is very fat for, like, smoking 2 packs a day.
And weighing, like, 10 pounds.
It's, like, genuinely shocking how fat he was at his age for how much he smoked. Because, like, it's impossible to... It's a major appetite suppressant.
His father, Muhammad, who introduced him to smoking, has to
at the age of 2? Like, what the fuck? How do you introduce a baby to smoking?
He insists that his son is healthy.
Oh, he said that. By the way, I haven't heard the F slur be referenced as a cigarette in the wild in forever, actually.
Yeah, I don't know. I almost never hear it ever.
Yeah, he just said it.
Wasn't calling the kid that.
No.
Luckily, Aldi's now in rehab under Indonesia's National Commission Child Protection Supervision.
They sent him to rehab. Do you think they had a intervention?
Damn, he's got the binky in one hand and then a fucking smoke in the other. He's like, this is great.
He's just going back and forth.
I know British people use it for cigarettes, chatter. I know. I'm just saying I've never heard a British person say it. So by the age of 5, he weighed 53 pounds, 13 pounds heavier than the average. His mother said Rizal would eat fatty foods and consume 3 cans of condensed milk each day. Oh, my God. Condensed milk slaps, though. If he didn't get his fix, he would bang his head on a wall, a tick he picked up while smoking as a toddler.
A tick he picked up? Why'd they let him do that?
Dude, he's so sick. But he made a complete turnaround the last few years, the Mail reported. He's now a moderately sized fourth grader, free of vice, focused on hanging out with his friends and passing the next grade. This story had a sad ending. He's
a loser.
Yeah, he quit smoking, and he does not look as cool as he did when he was smoking.
Yeah, poor guy peaked at 2.
What is this? The Jenna Ortega drama makes me think of his TikTok and all the comments on it. Thinking about that time, I had a poster of Zac Efron in my room when I was younger, and one day when I found out he had drank underage, I ripped it down, and I cried so hard for 2 hours that I threw up. Wait, he drank underage?
I don't know. Look it up.
This is so fucked up, dude.
How did he... Yeah, you're like real life.
What the
Wait,
fuck?
Is this a joke?
In eighth grade, I broke up with my boyfriend because he told me he tried the margarita mix in his parents' When Nick Jonas did the interview talking about taking off his purity ring, I locked myself in my bathroom on Thanksgiving to cry. My aunt brought me a plate. Yo, kids are so fucking dumb. I never had any of this shit.
Oh, I actually found another. It's not even.
You
on
have
this
something
list.
Like this? Did you have something in your past that like was traumatic for you that you found out about someone that you stand?
Nothing traumatic. But when I was in high school, I was kind of regret saying this. I was a 21 Pilots stan when I was in high school, like hardcore.
Uh huh.
And I was a hardcore Christian when I was in high school.
Oh hell yeah, I love that.
And they're like sort of like. Adjacently Christian as a band, like it's sort of tied to their image.
Oh, really? And I did not know that. Okay, go on.
I remember when we were in high school, one of my friends was like, dude, the lead singer Tyler, there's this photo of him like giving the middle finger to a camera. And I was like, that can't be true. I was like, he would never do that. I know he'd never do that. And I think it was actually a fake photo. I do think he didn't do it.
Oh, still to this day, you're denying the truth that he actually flipped the camera?
No, yeah, it's got to be. No, there's definitely some. But if you type in Dance Moms to TikTok. I found this TikTok of this girl talking about her being a part of the Dance Moms fandom when she was younger. And it was like insane shit. I was like, oh, let me find this. I can't find it.
There's no way I can find it like this, I'm pretty sure.
She's like a huge TikToker and was like talking about. Oh, yeah. Type in Dance Moms fandom.
People are saying this is a big one. Lexi J. Nanny Servant deleted video. Who's Lexi J? Yeah, dude.
I
just opened up the fucking Pandora's box, dude. There's floodgates here. The floodgates are opened. I don't want to be alarming, but Nick is not green. Is behind you. He's next to me. But you're right.
I'm not behind him.
People on here be like, cigarettes are bad for you. Source the FDA.
God. Then they add it. That's great.
This guy, look at this. Look, you're inhaling radioactive carbon particles straight to your lungs. Just take some coal and shove it down there and get it over with. Smoked for 17 years. Was hell to quit. If you want some nicotine, they have lozenges, gum, patches. Try that instead. Don't smoke. It's like...
Lozenges are for fucking nerds, dude.
Bro, fucking chill, dog. Like, it's a joke, man. What the hell is going on with everybody?
Radioactive carbon particles.
Like, I'm pretty sure everybody knows it's bad, right? Like, everyone knows it's bad. The patches are awful. The gum is better. Anyway.
Yeah, you got to see this Dance Moms thing.
Did you find it?
Just search Dance Moms fandom. First one.
Okay.
And it just, like, gets crazier and crazier. I was like, I didn't know this was a thing. And then people in the comments.
This?
Yeah, this is it.
Here are some of the most batshit crazy things I did when I was in the Dance Moms fandom. And yes, it's, like, actually insane. So my cousin May, who's the same age as me, we were in the Dance Moms fandom at the exact same time. We both had our Instagram fan pages. We met the entire original cast together. We had each other.
I don't understand. Why? There's stands for Dance Moms?
Yeah, and it was a huge thing. Look, people in the comments know her by her fandom name when she was like in it. She was one of like
Kendall Vertez XO Stop No Way.
Yeah, there's look at if you keep going down, you can see like so many people are like, oh my god, I remember you.
Batty, I co-owned Teen Ziegler's. I'm pretty sure we were friends. No way, I vividly remember your PFP. Yo, this is not normal.
Just
I'm too old for this shit.
Each other's passwords.
I like her
and
glasses.
One day
though.
We got into a fight, so I logged into her account and pretended that she got hacked. I was posting like black pictures, like, yeah, this is the hacker, and you're never getting this account back. Then I was just bored of it, so I was like, oh, give me your email, and I'll give you the account back. I didn't tell her till like years later. She also did me dirty once though. In the Dance Moms fandom, we have these things called twinnies, which is basically just like two internet best friends. So in your bio, you'd put like twinny at, and then whoever it was. My twinny was not my cousin, but this like random other stan, like my age, I found online. We FaceTimed like a couple times. But my cousin knew my twinny and for some reason decided to hack her. I did not speak to my very real cousin, blood relative, for like 5 months because she hacked some girl I had spoken to like twice online. This next one is an insane thing to admit online, but what I have no shame. I used to pretend to be a student at the ALDC through Photoshop. And I definitely still have these pictures on my computer back at home, so I might have to make a follow-up video. I would Photoshop myself like into the studio, or like I would literally find people who went to the studio but weren't on the show, so they didn't have a ton of followers. I would take their pictures of like either they were in the studio or they had like the dance sports bra on, and I would just like put my face on their face. My cousin May did the exact same thing.
Bro, this is literally like, that's like, I think you were like developing like a psychopathy like
yeah,
early.
And I learned she's like 20, so this happened maybe like not even 10 years ago, and it gets like I'm still like it gets worse.
I mean, I'm glad that like this 10-year-old is no longer like hyper mentally ill, you know what I mean?
I know, because I'm like, how do you grow up and become normal? Because I didn't that kind of stuff when I was young. I was never like,
I always thought I was like, there was something wrong with me because I didn't have like a fandom that I belonged to when I was younger. Like even in Turkey, like, you know, people loved sports teams or athletes or fucking Justin Bieber or some shit. And, like, I never had that. So I thought I had an issue. Like, I thought I was the problem. So then I, like, would lie. I would lie and be like, oh, yeah, I love Justin Bieber. You know what I mean? Like, I was, I'm such a big fan. I'm such a huge fan. Just to, like, get along with people, especially with soccer, football, where for me it was like, for me, it was like Fenerbahce. Like, you have to like Fenerbahce. It's one of the three major teams. You have Fenerbahce, Galatasaray, and Beşiktaş. And I had to like, I had to basically lie and learn things about Fenerbahce so that like when people questioned my fandom, I had information readily available to just say that I know what the fuck I'm talking about. It was so sad.
Just like memorize the player's name.
Yeah, it literally, bro. It actually. Legitimately created animosity within me towards sports. Like, I just hate watching organized sports because of that, I think. Because I did this. You do this with rap music? Not even. I'm very honest about not listening to music and shit like that. So I don't care. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, wait. We gotta... I'm trying to remember what the later one is, but she does this thing where she tells this long story, and then at the end she like puts in like 10 different... She does all these mini things that are crazy that are all like insane, but like leaves it just... I would just keep watching. It's freaking.
Thing too, so I feel more justified. We were both like absolutely crazy. Something else we did together. We used to go on Uvu calls with other members of the ALDC who weren't on the show but were friends with the girls on the show. I don't want to name drop, but anyone who like watched the show or know anything about the ALDC probably would know who I'm talking about. Me and my cousin would go on these Uvu calls and put on like insane makeup, like unibrows, lipstick, do our hair crazy. We would speak in like insane voices and do the weirdest things. Like we put apple juice in cups and said that we were drinking our own pee. I don't know why she always answered our Uvu calls, but we would like terrorize them on Uvu. So obviously because we were acting crazy, the girl who were on
the... What the fuck is Uvu?
So Uvu was a thing when I was like in middle school, and it was like, it was like group FaceTime, but like first app to do it, where it was like, oh, you can go on and you can call it, like get on a call with like 8 people and you can't hear anything because there's so much feedback, and it was like awful. But people used it because that was the only way you could Skype more than one person. Yep.
Never even heard of it.
Phone with was like going to show everyone she's with. And one time we had like Kenzie watching us on Uvu, like... And we were like, show her again, but she wanted nothing to do with it. We ended up getting into hella beef with the girl we were Uvuing. Like, we ended up DMing her mom and being like, your daughter is a disgrace. I don't know what she said to us, what we said to her. But yeah, we ended up blocked, so that was an era. I don't know if anyone remembers Dance Mom's, like, fanfic Instagram accounts, where each part would be posted as, like, a different post, and the caption has the actual fanfic. But yes, I had my own fanfiction account. I wrote a story once about Maddie and Chloe getting kidnapped. I used to steal edits from YouTube and just post like, them as my own on my Instagram.
Just like using these children as like characters in fan fiction that isn't like romantic or anything. Just like telling a story.
What the fuck? She's talking about fanfic about minors and their moms as teachers. Yeah, she was like 10, okay? Chatter, like...
It wasn't like sexual.
Yeah, and she wasn't like this adult. That's another thing on the internet where people are like, oh, dude, you're doing this right now. Like, yeah. No, she was doing this when she was also a 10-year-old, okay?
No age gap, guys.
Yeah, no problematic age gaps here.
All of the original cast, like, phone numbers.
It's still insane, by the way. That's what makes it even more unhinged in many ways. Like, if an adult is doing this, you're like, okay, I can neatly categorize this as a gross pervert who should be institutionalized. But, like, when a child is doing this, you're like, what the fuck? Like, I don't even know what kind of box to put you in. I don't know how to neatly define the circumstances and how to deal with this kind of thing.
Yeah, it's serial killer shit.
Online, they were definitely not real, and I had a notebook with all of them written down. Also had a fan page for Kendall's old duet partner at Studio 19, Lainey. I would go on Skype calls with her like multiple times a month. Also had a Mia Diaz fan page. She was on Dance Moms Miami. Also used to Skype her multiple times a month. Oh, and I had my meet and greet autographs framed on my wall, but I don't know if that's that weird. Here are some of the most bad...
No, that's... You know,
I don't know why she even said that.
That's like the most normal part of this. To be fair, they did a dance on the show reenacting a kidnapping, probably where that came from. It's still weird to write fan fiction about, like, a reality TV show of, like, children that are dancing that you're watching and obsessed with.
Yeah.
This sounds like Frogan's old Twitter days. Yes, Frogan is, like, an OG stan of, like, everyone that you can think of. Not limited to Maddie Healy, as a matter of fact.
Wow, yeah.
Yeah. So I just... But they were also kids. No, I know. It's, like... But it's still kind of weird that, like, a child was doing it. Because, like, I feel like this is the type of shit that, like, you know, adults do.
Yeah, like, because they're freaks.
Yeah, they're, like, freak-ass adults do this shit, you know what I mean? So when a child does it, you're like, how did you learn this? Like, how did you come up with this behavior? And I guess it's, like, unsupervised internet access for a kid.
Yeah, this is... I don't know. We have to censor the internet, I think.
Yeah, no, China is right with the way that they behave on restricting internet access to children. Like, they're so right about it. And, you know, fuck it. We don't do it here. We're never going to do it. It would probably hurt our businesses, let's be real, what we do for a living. But still, this is literally what grown adults do with QAnon. Yeah, I guess as long as, like, you get it out of your system and then you're no longer, like, you recognize that it's, like, weird, wild, stupid, you know, it's good. It's good that you are no longer doing that, I think. Maybe these adults would not be QAnon adults if they did the stand-up shit when they were younger.
Yeah, maybe that QAnon kid from that one video should he just needs to like get into a band or like a reality TV show, and then he'll stop like.
You know. Yeah, yeah, it's like a more productive hobby and stand-up. As if children haven't always been writing fan episodes of shows they love forever. I guess they are. I don't know. I never did this shit, so I mean, it's like weird to me. But it's cool, I guess. Okay, what is this? This seems like a crime.
Oh, I can't wait.
Lexi J. Who's Lexi J? Is she a TikToker? You should know this.
I have no idea.
You're the TikTok expert.
Lexi J. Could
one of the best parts about TikTok is always like some children get into some like fucking drama or some shit. And then you have, like, grown-ass adults analyzing the drama in, like, the most serious tone ever.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? And you're like, but you're an adult. Why are you so scoldy, kind of? I don't know. Let's see what this is.
Dad is iconic, but I want to introduce you to the real legend of the family, Elena. She lived with my family for about 30 years. And about 6 months ago, she decided it was time for her to move back to the Philippines. She got me ready for my first day of preschool, moved me into my college dorm and everything in between. So taking her back to the Philippines was something I could not have wanted to do more.
You're going to the Philippines?
Yes, I'm going to the Philippines. I have to take her home. It had been over 30 years since Nanny had last been to the Philippines. She sacrificed raising her son and daughter to get a job in America and send every dollar she could back home to her family. She is the hardest worker.
She sacrificed her son and daughter?
Hell, yet somehow she's the smiliest, happiest person I have ever met. Before I knew it, it was time to head to LAX. And when I tell you, I have...
Why does she post this? Like, this is like... Bro, you can't be posting stuff like this online. Like, what the fuck?
This is insane.
Yeah, because, like, of course, everyone is going to look at this and go, like, oh, my God, you had, like, a live-in servant. You know what I mean?
I released her back to her home country.
This is Don't worry. Oh, Jesus Christ. Like, if you ask the nanny herself, right? Like, I'm sure she has, like, a... She has a perspective that is not as, like, aggressive as everyone else that's, like, talking about it. But even then, you know what I mean? You're describing, like, third world exploitation. like basically slavery that we have normalized because, you know, it's the Philippines.
I've never experienced heartbreak like this before. God, I love this woman so much. The princess, as I like to call her, was of course chauffeured all around LAX. She made so many friends, we got a ton of snacks, and we were ready for the longest flight ever. We had a tearful goodbye to America. She thanked it for everything it had brought to her. I cursed it for not letting her stay forever. We held hands the majority of the flight, and before I knew it...
Oh, she has to go home. Wait. Oh my God, wait, she's being deported? What the fuck?
Wait, that's...
Yo. This story is insane. The part, what? That makes it so much worse. Bro, why didn't you, like, here's how you could have made this story maybe a little bit more manageable. Even then, people will get mad at you, okay?
Oh my God.
Work with immigration lawyers to, like, ensure that she gets documentation, the proper documentation, and, like, bring her fucking family here. Like, what are you doing? You didn't... This is just like, oh yeah, my family used and abused our servant for 30 years and then didn't even sponsor her. And then I just basically shipped her ass back to fucking the Philippines. Yeah, you already know this, but in the Philippines, they do this a lot, but it's usually nursing and not being a maid. Maids are super normal in the Philippines, but they aren't like this.
Yeah, I
what
mean,
the fuck?
I think it's a lot different if like your white family in America, like, you know.
No, I mean,
you.
Dude, really, really poor countries like the Philippines are hyper reliant basically on this kind of thing where like they work in either the cruise sector in like horrible work conditions for the record, or they work in like nursing homes and things of that nature. Yeah. They're in like the the healthcare, like adult healthcare industry for the most part. Like, it just sucks. And it's just one incredible way that America can keep importing cheap.
Yeah. I mean, it's a huge
cheap labor.
Thing. Like, especially, I always see it with like Filipino grandparents. It's always about like, oh, they came here so they could make money to move back to the Philippines. Like, it's always just this like, we couldn't, can't make it happen there, and so you're shipped over here, and hopefully, like, before you die,
yeah,
you make enough to go back.
Yeah. She said that the lawyer advised her not to go back home and her children couldn't visit her, the nanny. Yeah, it's like, that's odd.
We were in the Philippines. All sorts of things were going through my head at this point. Will nanny's family take good care of her? Will they resent me? How will she fit in? Will she be homesick for America?
Will they resent me? It's like, hey, this is your mom who was my mom because my mom was like not available. Also, what is this? What is the feedback here? What, like, this is a thing that I will never understand, okay? This is a thing that they do on TikTok. Which is, like, I guess funny for me to say because, like, I do react to a lot of videos and, like, yeah, everybody yeah. always says, like, oh, you're fucking, sometimes I'll take a piss in the middle of that react. So, like, you know, there's that brief moment of my fucking chair being there. But I don't understand when you're not, like, transforming anything. You're just, like, looking angrily during the entire TikTok. Like, it doesn't really bring anything new to the table. You know what I mean? Like, I don't understand why they do that. Literally what you do, Lamau. Yeah. Famously, I don't react at all. 13-month subscriber, which is precisely the reason why every fucking react I have is like 8 hours long when the original content was like 30 seconds. Okay.
Will they resent me? How will she fit in? Will she be homesick for America? I was so anxious. I cannot even tell you.
This is insane. I cannot believe we're
Stay
watching.
Tuned for part Hugging two. Your daughter my for the time. First time.
No, that wasn't bad enough. Before she deleted the video, somebody had commented this and said, why does she never get to visit her home during the 30 years? That's crazy. Lexi replied back and said her immigration lawyers advised her not to and advised her kids not to visit. It was her decision to stay here as long as she did. That's wild. It is. Now imagine in the coming days, a bunch of legal eagles as well as immigration attorneys are going to come out and challenge the statement below. But tell me what you guys think of this story. How crazy is it that in 2023, people still have nannies who are separate.
Wait, what the fuck? That's like, that's definitely a thing that's like.
Oh, so I grew up with God. A child.
Okay, so then this is her. Wait, is this her apology? Well, this is fresh. Hell this yeah. is like fresh out the fucking. Oh, it's 6 days ago. Well, it has 8,000 likes. So that's why I was like, I thought maybe it's like it just came out or something.
How many
so,
apologies have we
watched? I don't know who Lexi J is, but it seems like she only has 119. 1,000 followers. So what does she do? Like, what's her deal?
Wild.
Chat, what's her deal? The people who like posted this should at least give me.
I need to go to the bathroom. How do you not?
I do.
Where's your bathroom?
Outside, make a left. Also, our Sweet Greens food is here and has been here for a minute, probably for an hour almost outside. She's filthy rich and nothing more. Wait, that's it? She's just white, blonde, and rich? Get the fuck out of here, dude. What, next thing you're telling me that at the top of the hour, there's not a 3-minute ad break, you know what I mean? Only because you don't realize that there is a 3-minute ad break, as a matter of fact. But you haven't seen it because you have subscribed to me. That's right. If you want to make sure that you never see the top of the hour ad break ever again, that's all you need to do. Subscribe for $5 or free with Twitch Prime by connecting your Amazon Prime account to your Twitch account where you get one free Prime subscription a month. Use it on your favorite broadcaster. Hopefully that's me. You can also get gifted a sub if you're lucky. Guapoco and not a weeb. Thank you for the 5 subs, allowing 10 people total to no longer see the ads at the top of the hour. Here's the 3-minute ad break now. Sakura Gore, thank you for the 5 gifted. She could afford a live-in slave. Of course she's rich. No, the reason why she could afford a live-in slave is not because she's rich. The reason why she could afford to live in slave is because American imperialism has created an environment that is only sustainable with third world exploitation, specifically labor as a main import. She is 29 and her dad is 92 and her brothers are in her 60s. Wait, what the fuck? also because she's rich, but it's certainly because, like I said, it's because she's rich, but it's also certainly because she's, you know, because American imperialism. Wait, she's 29? This lady is 29 years old? Bro, I thought she was like 17, 18. That's why she was like posting these like ridiculous things. Not realizing that like you're going to get fucking super canceled for this or for understandable reasons. I shouldn't have sent that. Bro, if she's 29, am I like 80? What the fuck is this? Yeah, she's 29 years old. She got that drinking child's blood money. Wait, did you grab the... Wait, let me grab the salad. You forgot the salad, brother. Wait, grab two forks too. And also, if you want a drink, there's drinks in the fridge. How was she on TikTok? Her nanny worked at home for her dad.
Childhood nanny named Elena. Yesterday, I sat down and filmed a lengthy video going into the details of her immigration process as well as her employment. Before posting that video, I called Elena and shared it with her. She asked that I do not share those details of her life. Her word to me is the most important thing, and I will honor that.
Honestly, calling that lady a slave is a very first world privileged leftist thing to say. You are all exploited in the third world. You are all citizens of the empire. Yes, I 100% agree with that. No, she is in that condition. She probably does not even hate the condition that she's in. That's what I was trying to explain here. Okay? She probably does not even hate the condition that she's in. You want to know why? No, this is... Or wait, no, this is mine, yeah. You want to know why? Because of how fucking eviscerated we have left places like the Philippines, okay? In comparison to other people from wherever she's from, she's probably doing much, much better. That's the luckiest person in the village in that regard.
Nick, live in service. I get the salad. I actually found... For the first time, I guessed which word the forks were in, and I was right.
You're great. You know. Oh, fuck! I almost got it, but I did not get it. Okay. Poor in the first world was rich in the third. Oh, 100%.
She reminded me that she and I know the truth of our relationship. That is what matters most, and that hateful people are not interested in understanding. I want to make it clear that I agree with how broken the immigration process is. Separately, I'd like to make it clear that Elena received a competitive wage for her work. Prior to her work with my family, she worked-
Yes, she got to live in the wealth of empire and send money to a home to her family, which is like a huge reason, like a huge way, I mean, but part of the biggest reason why I am a big advocate for, open borders and better immigration policies, she did probably feel lucky and privileged herself, but that doesn't change the actual reality, okay? What did she say?
Immigration process is. Separately, I'd like to make it clear that Elena received a competitive wage for her work. Prior to her work with my...
Bro, she's talking about this woman who couldn't see her fucking children for 30 years.
30 years. That's crazy.
As though this was like a part of the brain drain. You know what I mean? Like she was like, oh yeah, she was offered a competitive wage and a 401k. Like, no, she wasn't.
She's like, I also don't like the immigration policies, guys. Like,
yeah, but I will be a beneficiary of it in the imperial core.
And also, like, paying someone a competitive wage doesn't mean anything if they have to, like, live there permanently. Like, what's the point of making money at your job if you live at your job? I guess she, like, is sending money home to her family, yeah. But, like, that is kind of a fucked up way to make money for your family is by not getting to have one.
My family, she worked with many other families within the U.S. I cannot speak to her sacrifices and decisions, but I will say that every year she continued to choose to work with my family. It was one of our biggest blessings. Elena is the most incredible human with the most incredible soul, and I could not be more proud to consider her one of the three pillars that raised me. All of my grandparents passed before I was born, so I cannot speak to that traditional relationship, but in my heart, she is that and then some. My relationship with Elena was normalized to me. She has been in my life since I was 3 weeks old. It is very, very painful to unpack why someone would end up as an undocumented citizen in America, but reducing her life and her story to nothing but pain and sadness is untrue and disrespectful. She has a full life with hobbies and travel.
This is what I mean when I say is the banality of evil. Like, on paper, what she's describing is just like an outcome of just incredibly evil policies that led a person so far away from home to make these tremendous sacrifices. Okay? But the way that you describe it as though you are the victim here in this circumstance is like pretty obvious. Like, it's just so normalized. This level of evil is so fucking normalized. You know what I mean? Because the status quo is awful. I want to explain precisely why this video and the situation it depicts is so heinous for those that don't get it. First, more details on the situation. This woman is in the USA for 30 years working for his family and was not able to leave according to the video creator. There is one reason for this and one reason only. She did not have a work visa. So this family employed her for 30 years, did not sponsor her as an employee to help her regularize her migration status and let her visa expire. Her having been on an expired visa obviously means that she was in the country illegally and being employed illegally by this family. This means she had no real labor protections and no recourse against them. As if she complained, she could have been investigated and deported. This is a huge part of our agricultural production too. This is why a lot of these facilities, poultry, and pretty much every kind of agricultural output is done by undocumented immigrants who are in that position with no legal way to regularize their migrant status, because it's much cheaper to do so. There's no protections for them, and you can utilize the INS or the Immigration Customs enforcement to your advantage whenever there is any kind of like labor complaints coming from these workers who you are underpaying anyway. Again, the family did nothing to help her with this. In fact, if anything, her precarious migration status was beneficial for them because it meant they could exploit her and control her more and avoid giving her benefits, the minimum wage, etc. She was legally an unperson. That's true. Yeah. The her migration lawyer part is especially suspect. Having a lawyer who is yours rather than just someone you got advice from once or twice is incredibly expensive. There's no way she was able to pay for it herself. So was this lawyer actually employed by the family then? The implication for that possibility are clear. A lawyer employed by the family told her that she shouldn't leave the country, which obviously is great for them as they keep their house slave, just adding to the already numerous ethical issues with this situation. In 30 years, after so obviously and clearly seeking out an informal migrant, they never helped her regularize her migration status, leaving her in a highly precarious situation where she had little control over anything about her life slash no ability to travel. Even despite that, even if we accept this notion that she personally couldn't travel, her employers could have paid for visits from her family, who is noted she hadn't seen in 30 years. They did not. These are people rich enough to have a living maid. Obviously, they could afford it. They clearly do not actually love her or consider her part of the family, as this American girl implies in her TikTok. They did nothing for her aside from the bare minimum. The best years of her life were spent toiling for another family while she was kept away from seeing her own. And why does this situation exist in the first place? Because of the upper class families like this, who concentrated their class power in the past to further colonialism, like the Philippines was literally a United States colony, and who are still the driving force behind imperialism today. The same imperialism that keeps countries like the Philippines poor, that causes people like this to take drastic measures, living abroad for 30 years without ever going home, working for the very class of people who put people like her into that situation. Everything about the situation is fucked up. The woman who made this TikTok has absolutely no concept of what her and her family have done to this woman and her family For her, it's an opportunity to make a fun TikTok for Internet Cloud. It's disgusting. And yes, you can absolutely sponsor a domestic worker for a temporary work visa up to 3 years. And then you can sponsor them for a permanent residency. They want to cheap, precarious labor they could exploit, so they didn't do this in the beginning. Absolutely true. 100%. She was in the situation of being unable to travel for 30 years because the family did not formally employ her at the start. Because of that, she came to have no formal status, so she could only leave once before being banned from re-entering again. Obviously, that's a great situation for the family exploiting her to put her into a domestic worker who does everything for them, who can't leave until she retires, who has no legal protections or recourse to abuse. It's so gross, man.
Yeah. 30 years. That's a while. Like, yeah. That's crazy that she had children and then, like, it was like, okay, well, I'm not going to see you till, like, you're an adult. Man. I'm like...
Yeah. Like, you could have, like, grandchildren even that you don't fucking know about at that point. Anyway, there's so many people in the U.S. that don't get happy little TikToks about it.
Making the TikTok about it is crazy.
But yeah. Like, no one would have known if you didn't choose to, like, do this for clout, by the way. So, that's what's wild about this drama. I worked in a vegetation process plant for 2 days. It was hell for next to no money and chock full of migrants getting splashed with water and freezing temperatures, 30 degrees Fahrenheit at all times. So many Americans have zero clue. Yeah. Coming from a country with an awful history of slavery, one of the ways that the mentality persists till this day is she's part of the family, like the family, which only serves to make the worker have no boundaries, work free time. So working 24/7, it's super insidious, but seemingly innocent. Yeah. Okay. So that's another drama that we explored. What else you got for us?
Okay. I'm saving my best for my main story. This one, the freak kindergarten one's pretty funny because this video came up and then I found a stitch of this video.
This is what my daughter...
Lady who just like... Just watch this first and then I'll explain the next one.
Okay.
This is what my daughter did at school today. She did this to her whole classroom.
Okay, this is a Damien situation.
So I'm picking my daughter up from school.
A what situation?
Damien, like Omen, a devil child.
Oh, yeah.
They had to evacuate her classroom.
What? What is this music? What's happening there? Why did she put a soundtrack to her fucking demon child?
I don't know, but what I do know is I found this TikTok of this mom who stitched this video and was like way too serious about it, as if her child was personally harmed by this, and it's just one of those like conservative ladies that cracks me up.
Unpopular opinion incoming.
They had
Uh-oh.
To evacuate her classroom.
This is probably an unpopular opinion. And I'm completely fine with that.
This child needs to be killed before she can do more harm.
Snipe this child.
Your child does not belong in a classroom with mine. Period.
Oh, what the fuck? Get your fucking child out of school, bitch.
Demon kid.
Okay. While I can empathize with your situation, my first and truly only priority is to my children. Okay.
So. Why is she fantasizing about a situation where she's, like, been harmed by this personally?
That's what I'm saying. Like,
bro, oh, yeah, I was going to say you can get a new fork if you want, but fuck it. YOLO.
Fuck. I don't even care anymore. Yeah, I watched this and was like, oh, my God, why did she get so mad about a video that looked like it was taken, like, 10 years ago? And then rants about how, like, unpopular opinion to say, like...
It's because she's bored, okay? Like 95% of like conservative, wine mom talk is basically just like, I'm bored. I have no adversity in my life. So I'm making up hypothetical scenarios where I will be doing shower thought style arguments against. That's what they do. Suburban white moms are so bored. Yeah.
As a parent, I'm responsible for advocating for my children the same way.
Bro, she's got real like... we got to bang these gay books energy at the PTA. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, well,
it's like, lady, you homeschool your children. Why are you here? It's like, well, you know, I don't want other children to be queer.
This might be an unpopular opinion.
Right? As my children's advocate, my number one priority is their safety and well-being. Does this look safe to you?
No one said it did. Like, no one said anything. The lady making the TikTok obviously knew it was an issue. But I'm like, why, like...
What is this?
Hello, everyone. Oh, no, 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 wait. This is a spoiler for later.
Okay,
don't watch that.
I know, I think I know what it is. I saw a brief glance at this.
Oh, yeah.
Earlier today when I was like, what the fuck is this shit?
Yesterday I spent like an hour, like, it was just...
I'm very excited for that proportion. Yeah.
Click the third link. This is just like me going down the rabbit hole of...
Oh, just
bless your heart. Silly ass liberals always want shit.
Yes! Yes!
I was like, there we go.
And she got the Hogwarts t-shirt on. God damn it. I love her. I love her.
Bless your heart. Silly ass liberals always want shit for free. Let me explain something to you, though, about how free public education works, right? It's not really free, is it?
Oh, she's going to say,
no.
Wait, how...
No.
How is
it
funded?
It's paid for by those of us who own property.
Oh! No fucking owned!
I've never heard it put that way before.
We pay property taxes that fund public education. So we can...
Which means I can fly down to your zip code and beat the shit out of your problem child.
I'll do it myself.
I'll go down there. Listen. I'm in Arkansas, but I will come down there to fucking, I was thinking of, where, Terre Haute, Indiana, and I'll beat the shit out of your problem child.
You ever been to Indiana?
Fuck no, dude. Terre Haute, Indiana is like, the only reason why I bring it up is because it's an E1 reference. Episode 1 is a podcast. Shouts out to the Hudsons.
Yeah, Indiana's a bad place.
Yeah. It's just, like, permanently stuck in my mind. That's where they execute terrorists. Yeah, isn't there a prison there? It's like a prison city.
Yeah, it's like Gotham over there.
But we get a say in what happens, right? Now, I know that sometimes y'all struggle with things like rights and freedoms and civil liberties. Kind of like with that jab, right? Like y'all wanted everybody to get stuck just because you did, okay?
Oh, there it is.
However, that child's right to a free public education ends where my child's right to a safe learning environment begins.
How much you want to bet she homeschools her children, dude?
She doesn't. It's... so funny. I was like, how is this even like...
Oh, never mind. She's not. This part. I made it a point to regularly buy things for our teachers from Amazon wish lists. I homeschool mine, and yet I still pay for others' education.
Christina, you're the one paying for everyone's education.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I mean, that's how it's done. It's through my property taxes. I love her. Okay, what else? What do we got?
Okay.
Absolute freak actor guy? What the fuck is this?
You are an empty.
This isn't drama. I just like could not believe like I was watching these and I was like, this guy is
comparing my acting with the movie scenes they are taken from. Okay, this first of all, crying dudes is a staple in Indian TikTok, which longer exists, so When I see white guys in America doing it, I'm like, oh, nice. Like, this is for me. We respect crying guys that cry on TikTok.
Yeah.
But before I respect this guy, you can watch it and give your commentary on it. I got to go pee.
Okay. I'll do what I'm best at.
Empty, hollow shell of a woman. You are an empty, empty, hollow shell of a woman. It's not my daughter in there. Is that my daughter?
This one, is that my daughter in there is kind of like his main thing. Like he had a big TikTok. Sorry, I'm just taking over for the stream. Let's just watch my stuff. He has like a bunch of different TikToks of him specifically just doing the daughter scene. Oh, here it is. Finding my beautiful daughter dead. And then people thought it was... people were like, did this actually, like, did his... Like, this one. He apparently lost his daughter, and he's reaching out what actually happened on the day he found out. Please, everyone, be kind. Thoughts go to Yoy in the fam. But then up here it says, hashtag fiction. Hashtag fictional characters. Beautiful daughters in there.
And I wanna kiss you, make you feel alright. I'm just so tired
this is the police
to share my nights. I wanna cry and I wanna love, but all my tears
are cops, obviously. Yeah, so this is like, for all my Americans in the chat, this is what police is like in other countries, actually. So in the UK, you know, they it's just sort of like, wear what you want and we'll put the security vest over it. And then they like one line of tape. Game over. Oh, is he trying to be like Sean Penn? I think.
Is that my daughter?
But me! But me!
That's what is one of my favorite movies, Prisoners.
But me! But
I love when he does the scene from Prisoners. This is legendary.
Sorry, I'm taking over.
But me! But me!
Ghost.
Bro, what
this,
the
this
fuck?
Is the one that made me
bro,
copy the
what
link.
The fuck? Bro, he's just crying all the... Why is he crying so
His
much?
Eyes are so blue,
like, dude. I don't want to be like toxically masculine. Except fuck no, I do want to be toxically masculine. If you're crying this much, like there's something wrong with you, man.
Yeah, you're a fucking loser. Yeah, man.
Stop fucking crying, dog. What the hell is this shit?
Oh, you gotta watch this scene with the cops.
It's a Snapchat filter? Oh, wait. He's not even... So it's like he's faking it. That's PEDs, brother.
I don't know if he is. I don't know if that one's a Snapchat.
Okay, I gotta watch it from the top.
I've seen the filter.
Wait, what? Wait, what the fuck? Well, the weirdest part about it is the cop is the security guy here with the off-white belt. Yo, he's so... He's sick. That guy is nice with it.
Wait
but,
till you see them. They're full...
Okay, he has homies that did this with him? Like, they didn't stop him from putting this out there? Like, that's crazy.
No, they shot
him. Don't turn it!
They won't fly. And I wanna kiss you, make you feel alright.
So now the cops show up. They put up the tape. They're gonna guard the tape, too.
I wanna cry and I wanna love.
Yeah, I was explaining to everyone that this is what they look like in the UK.
Yeah, this is realistic.
You show up for your... He didn't even get stopped by
Why
that.
Did he fall like that? Wait, what the fuck? Wait. Bro, what? Dude, stop. Like, you can see his ass crack and shit, dude. Bro. Lower the emotions in this a little bit, man.
On another low.
Yo, I can't. Yeah, he does his own stunts, which is pretty cool.
He's like the next Tom Cruise.
Yeah. Don't turn
around. My tears being used on
the slow motion audio. That's awesome.
This is the first time I've seen a person who's like giving so much divorced dad energy, but simultaneously, I believe in my heart that he does not have a child.
No, this guy's by himself.
Yeah,
sure.
He's like he's never had a child, okay? Even though he does have endless amounts of divorced dad energies.
What? Was that supposed to be her?
That's the ugliest dead daughter mural I've ever seen.
She's like an angel and she's like hunched over.
Why does it look like your dead daughter is also like decapitating heads as an angel? Like, what the fuck is this?
Oh my God.
How does this have 1.5 million? Me making traumatic scenarios in my head. Movie budget all went to the police tape. So they set up a camera that did all this.
And then the other one, the TikTok, actually, the first one I pulled up is the one shows the scene that he's reenacting. That's not even a scene he came up with.
It's from some movie. Oh, so this actually is like a reenactment.
It's just a movie. Yeah, they just reenacted a movie scene.
I wonder what movie scene it was. Is this?
Yeah. Start this over. This is so classic.
You are an empty, empty, hollow shell of a woman. You are an empty, empty, hollow shell of a woman.
Imagine.
Damn. Wait.
Looked like that.
Why did he just show the same video twice?
Oh yeah. Did they just? I thought he just wanted to show us.
Yeah.
Show us again.
Yeah. He just copied it. Wait. What? It's so weird. It's like.
Maybe it's the same practicing versus him in the actual scene.
Yeah. That's so sick. I mean, he's so talented.
Empty. Empty. Hollow shell
of a woman. It's not my daughter in there. It's not my daughter in there.
But me. But me.
Why is he constantly fantasizing about his daughter being lost or
These
murdered?
These are all movies where his daughter's like... At least that one we just watched, and then this, Prisoners is also about that.
That's kind of weird. I mean, well, luckily we know he does not have a daughter, because I'm convinced he does not, okay? You can show me.
She'd be in the videos. They'd show photos of her.
But me! But me!
From those? You're too young for them. When the time comes,
the eyes are insane.
Treat them like princesses.
Two young girls right
now. Also, that's not how Denzel Washington acted out that scene.
Bro, this guy only cries.
He's like talking to some guy, like really quietly. And then this dude's staring.
It'd be really funny if there was a scene from like a comedy and he's still doing it while crying.
Still like losing his mind.
The only way he can reenact movies is if he's crying in them, like bawling his fucking eyes out.
Yeah, dude. I mean, what would you do if your daughter died, you know?
Yeah, he's permanently stuck in daughter death mode in every movie.
That's huge.
Treat them like princesses. When you watch a movie, especially drama, and actors are playing characters telling really hard-hitting stories, for example, like Hugh Jackman in Prisoners, like Sean Penn in Mystic River, like Denzel Washington in John Q, where some of my more popular videos have been taken from. I'm not doing anything different to what those actors did playing those characters in those movies.
Wow, I'm glad he did the explainer in the end of it. Like, he's like, I'm just like Denzel Washington.
It's hard. They have to draw from somewhere, you know?
Yeah, they drew from him.
Watch the TV show Barry.
I haven't seen the last season yet, but I was a big fan.
At least tomorrow. Of the whole show, guys.
Yeah.
I'm excited. Okay, so that guy, that's basically all I have from that guy.
Okay, that's not all he has. There's more. No, I want to look at more.
We could go, if you want to go on.
No, I want to see more of that. This is my, oh, fuck. I sent this to Felix. Felix Biederman of Chapo the other day. Let me see if I can find it. This is my favorite type of like guy who's like guy who has feelings, and that's why it has to be like he has feelings and he has feelings, and those feelings are he's expressing them without telling you he's hiding them. But that's like a big deal. So they make videos about this because they're always like theater kids. Let me see if I can find it real quick. Hold on. Oh, here it is. I mean, I don't even want to dunk on this guy because it seems like he's, like, actually going through some shit, but it is pretty funny. Wait, hold on. Ah. This. Let me see if I can find it. Hold on.
Chief Nitro.
Okay. So this guy's like actually going through some shit, I guess, but. Oh, here it is, here it is, here it is, here it is. Okay, okay, okay.
No way!
Okay, this, I don't know if like him actually going through some real shit makes this worse or funnier, okay? So, here, let's watch.
No way! No way! Amazing.
What compels what compels someone? Yeah, someone said, bro, go to your wife.
Dude, to just go
like
slowly turn and you look so
happy. I love this, okay? I love this so much. Cause it is so unintentionally hilarious that like this dude was literally like, my wife has cancer. Let's make that about myself real quick. While also I simultaneously like show you the corniest thing you've ever seen, okay?
And the way that he says like, me when my wife's cancer is like spreading to her bones and spleen. Yeah.
It's like, is it spreading through your bones, dude? What the fuck? It's
spreading through her bones and her spleen. Oh my God, look at the hashtags. Felicia Strong. Hashtag Felicia's Army. Hashtag stage four.
Hashtag metastatic or metastatic? Oh yeah, it is.
Hashtag get your boobies checked.
Yeah. Hashtag awareness. But bro, also, hashtag stage four, dude. That's crazy, okay?
When my wife didn't get her boobies checked.
We find out his wife doesn't have cancer. She's just like faking an elaborate death scheme to get away from him.
Trust me, this is going to be awesome. TikTok is going to be awesome.
I mean, dude, this is a wild thing, dude. It's a wild thing to do, okay? Actually, is this sympathy, Riz? I don't know what the fuck that is, but I personally love that he made that. It's great. More power to that guy. I hope he keeps making content like this. Okay, I got to see more of this guy, though.
Cheating wife is confronted by husband.
Wait, what?
Oh, no.
Setting the record straight.
Hello,
I'm an
everyone.
Actor.
The reason I wanted to make this video, because every month or two that goes by.
Okay, British people should not be allowed. Okay, just I'm gonna leave it at that.
No.
They should not be allowed. No, it's over.
I gain more followers. I like to always remind people I am an actor.
I'm glad he's reminding people that he's an actor, because when I was watching him crying, I truly thought his daughter had died.
For a second, I was like, holy shit, his daughter's dead.
And I had no sympathy for him because he was reacting in the lamest way possible. I was like, oh, wow. Like, I don't even feel bad anymore. What the fuck?
Cringe.
Such.
Bro, he's always crying.
He's like, do you guys need me to play like a sad character? I could do a sad character.
Like, you know how there's character actors? This guy's entire thing is like one thing that humans do.
It's one emotion. No way.
Yes, sir.
And that the content that I create and put out on my channel is purely fictional stories that either I create myself.
This is a nightmare.
Sometimes.
Wait, you're not a doctor? What the fuck?
I legitimately thought that was him doing his job.
He's so good.
He got a staff lanyard on his neck.
Or sometimes scenes taken from movies. One of my more recent videos went viral.
Is that my daughter in there?
15 million.
Discovering my daughter dead.
Kill him!
Was taken from a movie called Mystic River with Sean Penn.
There is zero people on this planet that watched that and went, oh my God, is this real?
I can't watch this guy.
No, dude. What the fuck, dude?
My daughter!
There was another video that I did recently finding my missing daughter.
Not you! But me!
That scene was taken from the movie Prisoners.
It does seem not so
you.
Close to
not you, but me.
That is
people have been like arguing whether or not it's satire, but like when you go through the amount of videos and the amount of shit he does, there's so much stuff that's like too good to be a joke.
Like, yeah,
just the way he.
Okay, you missed a missed a really important part of it. He said this is his style as an actor.
But so this me. Is
that scene was taken from the movie.
His style
with Hugh Jackman.
Not you. Not you, but me!
That is my style as an actor. Some of you do say, is that the only thing that I can do? I've always leaned towards emotional, dramatic side of acting.
I sad.
That is crazy.
Dude, it's so weird. His eyes are so, it's freaking me out.
It looks like that filter that they have, a filter that looks just like this on TikTok. And
he looks like the guy. Cool. He looks like the guy who got the fuck me up barber haircut. You know what I mean? Like,
what is going on?
He's got those eyes. Like, I'm saying, like, you know what I'm talking about, chat? Like, the dude, yeah, Brendan Fraser meme. Like,
that's the eyes. That's what I'm talking
about. Yeah, the Zaza eyes, bro. The fuck my shit up eyes. I don't understand.
I gotta find that filter. Oh, here it is.
Oh my, that's so scary. Oh,
wait, it won't show. This photo. Wait, hold on.
That's so fucking scary looking, dude, when the boof hits you back.
I found you a new heart.
I know some of you don't understand why I.
Oh, that's oh crazy. No. It's me.
That's what it seems like.
I look like that guy now.
Would spend time creating.
Now I need to do it. Now I need to do an explainer video telling them, like, everyone, it's fake. I wasn't crying like that.
It's my style.
It's just what I do. I'm an emotional actor.
...is of dramatic content and put myself in these pretend scenarios.
But these kind of like acting bits I see a lot on TikTok and are not really right.
And a lot of you do under.
Is that a hater?
Bro, this has 29 likes.
You bookmarked it.
You're one of the two bookmarks, brother. You bookmarked this just so you can use them in your video?
Not really right.
And a lot of
and
you
the criticism
do
is
understand
that, not
that
really
I am an
right.
actor.
Yeah.
And a lot of you do understand that I am just playing characters.
Wait.
To help spread awareness. I'm never making fun of it. For those of you that continue to support, thank you so much.
Awareness of what? Acting? What is he?
He's like, I'm not trying to offend anyone. And it's like, make fun of movie scenes.
Yeah. And he's like, I'm trying to spread awareness that acting is a profession. It's something that people know. I'm trying to spread awareness that my daughter was kidnapped.
I thought.
Terrifying. Whoa. Bro. She just fucking got up so quick. What the hell was that? I think she's starting to get. Starting to get warm. Starting to get fucking warm in here. Yeah.
Let her die.
Yeah, she's been kidnapped. Okay, so that's one guy. That was a real freak. Thank you. That was actually fire.
I'm glad we watched that one.
So we saw the kindergartner. We saw the freak.
You know about the school shooting ad.
Oh, yeah, dude. It was awesome.
Isn't that crazy? Did you watch it on TV?
Yeah.
So countless ups.
We've watched this so many times at this point, but like,
it's so funny. I knew you'd see that one.
It's fire, but like, also, you know, It was inevitable. I've made so many jokes on this, but, you know, we'll watch
it. Me this year, from a school shooting to having no idea what life is going to look like after college. Supportive Mental Health Awareness Month, I'm partnering with Bior Skincare to strip away the stigma of anxiety.
We want you to get it all out. Not only what's in your pores, but most importantly, what's on your mind, too.
Anxiety in my life has come in waves. I found myself recently struggling from seeing the effects of gun violence firsthand. I've had to intentionally set aside time for prioritizing my mental health.
I will never forget the feeling of terror that I had walking around campus for weeks.
This is the moment where I thought it was gonna like actually be a video of the shooting.
Yeah, like, because it gets so like, it seems like a parody the way she goes, you know, the the feeling of terror I had, all that shit. Especially she keeps going after this, and it's just like,
yeah, it's very fucked up.
In a place I considered home, with countless anxiety attacks to crying alone in my room at night. My message to you guys is that it's okay not to have it all together. Life continually changes, and your thoughts will too. Do things that make you happy, and know everything will work itself out.
Join me in Bior Skincare in speaking up about mental health by screenshotting this digital card and filling it out yourself.
Wait, so was it? Apparently, she wasn't even on campus. Shut the fuck up,
there's
dude.
No shot. There's no
you did not
shot.
Find this. Nick, you did not find this. This is like incredibly important pieces of information.
My journalism credibility,
dude,
is
what
going
the
down
fuck?
The drain.
Wait, stop. What's her name?
There's no. I'm not gonna believe it unless like
Cecily Max. Okay, we're looking it up. We're looking it up, dude.
No shot. I'm not.
Nick failed us. Nick Talk has failed us. Thank God we got the CIA in the chat. Okay.
I stand firm in the belief that there's no way. There's just not.
Cecily Max controversy. Immediately, whenever you search something, like the fucking first thing that comes up is just controversy. Immediately. Yeah. Okay, let's see what happened. This is the re-upload. She apologized for it, apparently. Since you want to bring it to public and act like the innocent victim, here's some receipts. Are you copying? Don't act like. Wait, what? This is.
Have anything to.
No. Why is it the. UK bikinis are so small. What?
So she's just. Wait, go to her TikTok.
No, this is just a re-upload of the thing, the OG thing.
Yeah, I want to see if she's posted stuff on her like account that's up still. That one. Yeah.
This is my go-to.
Click Gremlows. Click that video. Which one?
Summer natural makeup.
Oh, she's not that big. She's got like 27,000 followers. I'm so sorry about my partnership video. This was strictly meant to spread awareness about the struggles that I've had anxiety with since our school shooting. The partnership was not intended to come off as a product fixing the struggles I have since rather partner with the brand to spread awareness. Blah, blah, blah. Did not mean to desensitize a traumatic event that took place. Okay. So where the fuck is the actual shit? Oh, this is Brad Tremell.
Awesome.
No, this is a meme. Yeah, this is a meme. The war in Iraq was high-key problematic. Here's how we can do better moving forward. The background. Americans were being extra after they had their wig snatched on 9/11. Neocons saw this as a chance to flex on Saddam Hussein's 112.5 billion barrels of oil. The false motives. The Bush administration claimed Hussein had connections to Al-Qaeda, but that was all cap. They also claimed Hussein was harboring weapons of mass destruction, and that was all cap, too. The forever war. Tea was spilled about Bush and the Bush administration's lies. What was thought to be a quick opportunity for imperialism became an endless conflict where all sides were shook. Hundreds of thousands of civilian casualties at a $1.9 trillion price tag. Let's just say this was not a good look to the rest of the world. One third of Iraq veterans have been diagnosed with serious mental health problems. Wait, what?
Still a big yikes they live with daily.
Yeah. It's true. It's the biggest yike. Nearly 1 in 10 men reported experiencing some form of depression or anxiety, but less than half sought treatment. The right treatment right for you. Whether you're looking for free and anonymous support groups, evidence-backed medication, or individual talk therapy, HIMSS is here to help. We're proud to offer access to such experienced and respected mental health professionals. From psychiatrists to therapists to nurse practitioners, certified in mental health, you're in amazing hands. The HIMSS promise. We take mental health as seriously as we do our privacy. Why is this giving an ED pill ad? Because it is an ED pill ad that he made. It's a fake ED pill ad he made for HIMSS. It's not real.
Is he the one that did the other fake ad of, there's one that went viral that people thought. It was.
He did. He's done this a lot where people like take it seriously, unfortunately, sometimes. But
Oh, wait, he literally posted about the school shooting at down there.
Yeah, because he also does like cultural. He does like a lot of analysis too.
Yeah.
Incredible Stove Business are finding that the DEI consultants they hire are running programs that create even more identity-based hostility and are responding by hiring other DEI consultants who market themselves as not doing that. All of this is fake. That's awesome. I mean, he's very good at covering the insanity of online culture and spaces like that. Not even top comedians can write something like this. Well, I mean, he is right. He wrote it, so it's fake, and he came up with it. But the school shooting one was awesome. I mean, straight up, that was like that. That is like one of the best. That's Fulcrum, awesome. Not drama, but this guy's okay. Awesome.
This is another. Oh wait, start. I would start at the beginning. People in chat will know. Do you know this guy?
Yes, we know who Fulcrum is. Okay. He's all right. Like I used to like his stuff a lot, but I think he's like now kind of. He's been hanging out with like some weird motherfuckers.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. But this video is a not this one. The other one is. One that's just like a classic for me. Basically, he gets in a fight with this guy, this male Karen, as he calls it, who gets mad and thinks he's like fucking up or whatever.
Uh-huh.
And then Fulcrum gets kind of mad at him. And I'll let this part play out so you can see. But in the we'll see. I don't want to spoil anything.
If you're not already subscribed, you feel me? Follow me on all my socials at the top. You best believe it. God damn it. You feel me? I'm out here at the smoke shop. Damien, look, 925. We're just
hanging out with like Sneeko,
weed instead.
and Aiden lost.
Yeah, Yodi gang, I'm out here. I'm about to pour up in this one right here type shit. I'm about to take some blinker hits in the goddamn 7-Eleven. All right, my friends, so I got the fucking soda. Now I'm about to hit the 7-Eleven, and I'm about to pour this shit up, you feel me? I'm probably going to take some blinkers in this bitch too, you feel me? You best believe it, but I'm out here in Yodi land right now. I got the firework Vago and shit. Let's see what we can get going, bro. But Fulcrum, come in. Yup, Yodi gang, you feel me? You best believe it, goddammit. All right, Yodi fam, so I'm out here in the 7-Eleven. I got this firework.
His vibes have always been so nice.
So what we need to do.
He makes good music too.
Oh, he does?
I gotta get two cup stuffed right there type shit. Make sure you guys give this video a like, you feel me? This video is a fucking banger. The firework goddamn, what they call that shit? What the fuck do they call that shit right there, bro? I fucking forgot, but I'm about to pour this shit up right now, you feel me? I got the Habit Water Soluble Live Resin Strain Specific Indica Sleepy Time Mango. Oh wow, that shit smells like weed. But you can't pour the whole one.
So where's the...
I'm just pouring up, you feel me?
Right now?
What you gaining out of that one?
I got nothing out of this.
Oh, he starts filming him?
Yeah.
Make a YouTube video of you making a YouTube video.
Hell yeah, bro. What you gaining out of that one?
I got nothing out of this. Just some common courtesy.
Hell yeah, bro.
What are you doing?
I'm just pouring up, you feel me?
Trashing this 7-Eleven right now?
I don't know about trashing no 7-Eleven.
What's going on? You
buying
any of them?
Get out of my fucking face, bro.
Yeah?
Get out of my fucking face.
Oh, shit!
Bro. No, you better not do shit.
Do it on camera.
Get the fuck out of my face,
you're
bro.
You're on camera right now. You just tried to fight me. Call 911.
No, I said get the fuck out of my face,
bro. Call 911. He's coming up on me.
I'm not even talking to me.
Like
I'm not even talking to you, bro.
Bro, he almost, he used the razor scooter like a blicky, dude. He had it fucking ready, dude. He had that thing on him.
I'm not even.
He's like, give me your ankles, bitch.
Talking to you and you come up.
He's like, I will destroy your shins, motherfucker.
He's filming me, bro.
He's making a video trying to trash this place up.
I'm not trashing this place up, you little goofy ass, little fucking autistic ass motherfucker, goofy ass motherfucker. Autistic ass motherfucker, get your ass out the store.
What are you doing? You buying any of that or what's going on?
I bought this from the smoke shop right now. What the fuck are you talking about, bro? I bought this from the smoke shop right now.
He calls the guy autistic. Now skip to like 7 minutes when he's sitting down there.
Autistic at the end of the day, I just have to...
So in the same
video, that's definitely not cool at all. I don't have anything against people who are autistic at the end of the day. I just have to let that be known, you feel me?
Fucking respect, dog. Just.
The only reason
he hit him with the A, he hit him with the A word because he saw the Overwatch shirt. You know what I mean? Out and about.
Just wait.
I'm autistic. He visually was, bro. You could tell by the way he walked up to me. You can tell by the way he was talking to me and shit, bro. He's not normal, bro, because no one goes up to someone and just starts filming them like
So not only does he call the guy autistic, he keeps it in the video, apologizes later in the video, and then
says he's visually autistic and then implies that, like, autistic people are not normal. This has it all.
It's literally, like, the perfect video.
Yeah.
No one ever talks about it. And the moment I saw this, I was like, I've never seen anyone like this.
He's like, yo, he's on the spectrum. Feel me?
He's like, you have to back up 10 seconds. It's so funny. The lead up to him, like, doing the whole apology. Being like, I shouldn't have done that.
Video plan was to pour up in 7-Eleven and take blink.
Oh, shit.
But I got it poured up right here. Got the double cup. I'm probably not gonna make a whole video of me drinking this and like telling you guys how it affects me. My video plan was to pour up in 7-Eleven and take blinker hits in 7-Eleven, but obviously that didn't go down. I hate when I gotta lose my cool like that, you feel me? You feel me? I just lost my cool, you feel me? I know I called him, like, autistic a few times, you feel me? And that's definitely not cool at all. I don't have anything against people who are autistic at the end of the day. I just have to let that be known, you feel me?
Thank God.
Thank God he let it be known.
Yeah, it's good that he's
the only reason why I was calling him autistic is because he visually was, bro. You can tell by the way he walked up to me. You can tell by the way he was talking to me and shit, bro. He's not normal, bro, because no one goes up to someone and just starts filming them like
imagine
that.
Imagine something like this happens to you or me. Read the comments of his video. Like, imagine if, like, everyone.
Fulcrum so really got harassed by male Karens who love for himself and even apologized afterwards. We don't see many genuinely good YouTubers, and Damien's a breath of fresh air. Love it, Yoda Gang. This man is so Chillington. I love this man for being himself.
Oh, no.
Even as an autistic person myself, the man was doing too much. Like, if you start hitting blinkers in front, I won't mind. Just take me to Yodi Land with you. Fulcrum, the only YouTuber to actually stand up for himself. I came at you polite, even though he was immediately accusing you of trashing the store and stealing when you were just doing harmless Yodi Gang shit. As an autistic person, this was funny as fuck. I like him because you can tell he feels genuine remorse, even though he was fully in the right.
Oh, God, you gotta love him.
I mean, the dude was in the wrong for sure for, like, fucking brutal and weird. And, dude, I love this shit, dude. I fucking love. He's like, yo, you feel me? that boy ain't right, you feel me?
He's not normal. Yeah. When he says that, I'm just like.
He's got an Overwatch shirt on, feel me? In public, broad daylight, Yodi Gang.
Oh, you feel me?
Oh, that was great. Okay.
That was classic. Okay, let's get to the
Sorbet.
Top story of the day.
Okay.
So sorbet is this
uh-oh.
What?
But yeah, let me give my precursor. Sorbet is basically an American idol group. Idol groups are like basically like boy band, girl band.
Yeah.
South Korea, like J-pop, K-pop, like a lot of times they you know, everyone knows they pick like in create these groups in South Korea that become these, like,
mm-hmm.
whatever. And these girls in L.A. who are very into this culture have decided to create their own American version of what an idol group would be, which means that you would go to, like, basically for them, they'd go to anime conventions and, like, I think music that they make, but they never actually came around to releasing their music. It was more like, oh, we're going to do this show at this anime convention and this and that. And basically, they launched their group on TikTok, and this is the video of them doing their call-outs, which is, like, when they're doing performances, the fans have a certain, like, back and forth with each character. It'll all make sense. But just, the girl in the pink was under fire because of what her
Don't even go. I know where it's gonna go. I can already sense it.
I know you know where it's
going. Saw like this still image, and immediately I knew everything I needed to know about this in this particular situation. This is like Ollie London, but
yes, yeah.
But this time, you know, they didn't go the full distance, which is why they're cowards. Ollie at least was like, "Oh, I'm Jimin." Like he was walking around claiming he was Jimin.
Double down.
Once you press play, you can't go back. Oh, dude, it's already over. We're definitely looking at this. I'm just going to let you know. It's, you know, trigger warning, extremely cringe, okay?
One, two, so sweet. Hello, we are Sorbet. We are an idol group based in California, and today we wanted to teach you guys our call and responses.
Hello, I'm Alice, and I am the green member of Sorbet, and my emoji is a little four-leaf clover, and...
Before we continue, I just need to mention something. So, how is it that, like, K-pop and J-pop is directly American culture that they have, like, that they have, you know, latched onto?
Yeah.
And yet Americans are still unable to, like, recreate K-pop in America correctly.
Yeah, which I guess this is their... their idea of that, which is like creating this sort of like multimedia performance group that, but I don't know what the, they never teased the music. They said they were coming out with music, but.
This is such a good thing. It's a Google Translate of a Google Translate. Yeah. I don't know how the fuck this happened. Like, we had our boy band era, but that is over now. No, but like K-pop and J-pop and like girl pop groups and shit, like American boy bands and girl bands, like, you know, Destiny's Child, shit like that. Like, that is, like, the origination of what K-pop is. Like, it started off in the West. A lot of, like, Korean culture, obviously, and Japanese culture, for obvious reasons, is, like, heavily influenced by American culture and capitalism. And they also just took that and basically turned it into, like, a hyper-manufactured commodity, right? A product that you can... use. Why are you saying, oh, no, 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 no?
Afraid of what's to come.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. I'm a fucking Amerabu, too. Like, Jesus Christ.
With being a weeb, everyone has their...
Yeah, Spice Girls and the Beatles, don't get it twisted. Yeah, but, you know, it's like a... It's basically like a lot of OG... it's a lot of like OG Western pop culture and Western music that they incorporated, right, and recreated and did a fucking phenomenal job at doing so. And turns out they actually did it so well that like Americans can't like recreate it with the tools that they've been given to them.
Okay. So. All of this with the blanket of like there's nothing problematic about doing this inherently. Like there's no, you're allowed to be a fan of a certain culture or like thing, but there are like right and wrong ways to do that. Go ahead.
And I like to bring luck to all of my fans. So for my call and response, I sort of incorporate that. It's pretty simple. Basically, I'm just gonna go lucky, lucky, and then all together go Alice. Ready? Lucky, lucky, Alice! Thank you! Hello, everyone!
Here we go.
First of all, like, what's up? There's no, like, Koreans in fucking California. What are you doing? Like, why is it that they had to be white? Like, I just genuinely don't understand that. Like...
Yeah, just... Barry is the main character of this story.
There's not enough Korean Americans out there. We had to make sure that they were white, like, it seems like. Because they're just friends... Is this like a bunch of children that were just doing this, or is this like genuinely a product? It seems like it's a bunch of kids.
There is a point I want to make later in this where I find another American, what they call them is overseas idol group. That's what they're called. If they're not in whatever.
Bro, I'm sorry. White people have fucking, they are on the downtrend, brother. Oh my God, like 90% of pop culture music was like directly stolen from black people, and now you motherfuckers can't even steal back the shit that they originally appropriated from you in the form of K-pop and J-pop. Yo, white people are, they're, they're, They have suffered, okay? I did not realize that white people fucking fell off this hard. You go from Motown to like to just like directly stealing rock and roll music from black people to this? That's crazy. You can't even recreate K-pop? What the fuck is your shit? I'm just saying, like, dude, we maybe Trump was right, dude. Why people need to make a resurgence or something? What the fuck's going on?
My name is Barry, and I'm the leader and pink member of Sorbet. So I'm going to teach you my call and response. So I start out by saying, strawberry. And then you repeat back, blueberry. And when I ask, who's everyone's sweet idol? You're going to say, Betty John. Are you ready? Strawberry!
Blueberry!
Minna no amai idol wa?
Betty John!
Hi hi, Betty desu!
Yo! It's okay, her boyfriend is Japanese? Yo!
Oh, you just wait.
What the fuck just happened, dude?
I love this so much.
This is what you do when you try to speak Japanese, by the way. Yeah, I know, but I'm not being serious when I do that. I'm making fun of myself when I do that. She's being serious when she does that. You can't make this comparison.
Okay, so
there is a major difference between me saying white boy swaggu to a Japanese person, asking them if they know what that is, a concept that I fucking made up, where I'm the one who's being fucking cringe, versus these people literally taking themselves seriously in this regard. Holy fuck.
Yeah. So that's the what started it all. And before I get to the apology, I think you should just look through Sorbet page to get an idea of.
No, we gotta finish this first.
Hi guys, I'm Ash. I'm the red
this
number.
This call and response was also kind of poked fun at because it's so long.
My Oshimaru, it's the red dragon mahjong tile. Quick history lesson. My call response includes 2 moves.
Dude, there's something really sad about this, actually. Now that I'm looking at this, like, they just, like, got dressed up and shit. Like, it's just, like, so cringe and so lame that I almost feel bad making fun of them. And then I'm reminded of this moment, and I'm, like, right back into it.
Strawberry! And then you repeat back, blueberry! And when I...
Yeah, I'm, like, at first I'm, like, I can't make fun of them. But then, because it's, like, kind of sad... They're playing dress up, and then that comes back, and it's like, no, it's valid.
Trio, and then Kan is a four of a kind, which represents Sorbet, and as well as you guys. So mine's pretty long, but bear with me. It's gonna go clap, clap, on, clap, 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 Kan, clap, 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 and then I'm gonna call Zumo, which is a winning move in Mahjong.
Memorize this, guys.
And then I'm gonna go, it's my victory. All right, ready? 1, 2, clap, clap.
Victory!
Thank you, guys.
That was fire. Okay. Wait, so what? No notes. I assume you showed this to me because everyone's celebrating it.
Yeah, I knew you'd like it.
Yeah. Everyone's probably celebrating it, right? Guys, right?
So there's a couple of things. The two girls, the way this happened is that after this video, everybody, like TikTok's idea... Of this is that Barry is this like evil leader of the group who's like a racist piece of shit, but they love the other two friends.
Wait, no, they don't.
I'm not kidding. Everyone hypes the other What's two girls up as if they're not all friends with each other.
They're all friends with each other and they're all equally fucking cringe. What's wrong with motherfuckers on TikTok? They just like pick and choose.
No, it is literally go through the other Sorbet ones before you watch her. Response.
Where is Sorbet though? This is. Katsusu.
Go down where you see Bay official. Yeah.
Hey everyone, this is Barry.
So this is the apology, but I think you should.
No, we're not watching the apology yet. No. That's on the back burner. Wait, hold up. So
we gotta build up.
So they only have 29,000 followers. So it does seem like pre-debut California-based indie idols. Oh my god, we're currently being doxxed. Jesus Christ, dude. Fuck, man. Yo, people need to stop, dude. People
it's
need to
so
fucking
TikTok.
Stop.
This is like the most TikTok drama, and it fell into my hands yesterday. This literally happened like yesterday or a couple of days.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Yes, I'm that. I was really hoping that he will come through.
We are Sorbet, a new indie idol group based in California. follow to see more of our pre-debut journey. Let me get this straight. Korean text, but Japanese intro, but indie group. Yeah, that's the other thing is like, so I didn't want to say that at first because I didn't want to come across like racist or something, but like, they're all over the place with the culture and like what they're LARPing. Like, they're not just doing K-pop shit. They're doing like, they're like speaking Japanese sometimes. Like, what the fuck's going on?
Yeah, the third girl's game is, she did address this in her apology, but people were like getting mad at her because also her thing is from Mahjong, which is like originally a Chinese game. But she does, she did know like the history of it and it was like a specific sect.
Yeah,
of
what
Korean.
The fuck? No, they literally are like, we're a K-pop band, but we're like also appropriating Chinese elements and Japanese elements as well.
It's wild.
What the fuck is like, it's so American to just be like, you know, all things Asian.
With a white twist.
I love it, dude.
With the California.
You know, whatever. Twist. The broad group of Asians, you know, those guys.
Yeah, there's
no
one there.
Oh, man. I love Orientalism. So good. Okay, let's continue. What the fuck? Yo, they are not making it out the hood, okay? I'm just going to say it. It's not happening, okay?
They're also in, like...
not with this one.
It's so funny that they're also, like, doing this in Little Tokyo and, like, basically, like, dressing up and reenacting other, like, Japanese songs in front of Japanese people in L.A. And they're watching out there at the store doors, like...
Yeah. Japanese idol groups are and were a thing first. I never said that J-pop is not a thing.
Yeah,
I don't know why, like, you're, I don't know why you're, like, oddly defensive about a thing that I never even mentioned. I actually, as a matter of fact, literally mentioned what you think I did not mention when I said J-pop and K-pop. So.
I feel like this is, like, an,
No, this is, like, oh, my Twitch chat is literally just, like, Twitter.
I'm being, like, inducted into your first, like angry chatter moment.
Yeah.
Which is crazy to see it from this side. I feel like I met. Like, I was watching.
You see how fucking stupid people can be now. Yeah.
Now I'm behind the curtain. My bad, wasn't listening.
Yeah, it's like 90% of the time it's that.
Wait, so I was reminded by this comment that I screenshotted the other day. This reminded me of that where...
Oh. Join us in wishing our Red member Ash a very happy birthday. We filmed this during our very first meetup in Little Tokyo. They did a fucking meet. Who showed up to the meetup?
I think maybe they meant that them three met up.
Like, what the fuck's going on? I don't even understand who the fuck would be like, I did? Shut the fuck up. That'd be fire if that was real.
I'm going to DM you the tweet that reminded me of this.
Bro, like, literally, I feel like every random, like, any given random Korean girl clears these three, okay? I'm sorry. I feel like, don't, I will sometimes see, like, random fucking videos on, like, Twitter or on the TikTok timeline of, like, people getting together at a fucking mall and just, like, doing this for fun. And I feel like that shit looks infinitely more well-produced than this. You know what I mean?
Yeah, because they still do practically the same thing where it's like they're on stage and they have these dances and this and that, just without the crazy amount of production that they do in Japan and South Korea to, like, show people. So it's like, it's, I don't know, it's a lot. So yeah, everyone, the whole, like, tone that TikTok has took on it is that they love the other two, and this Barry girl is like some sort of like demon who is has them trapped.
What's wrong with people? Like, is there like a thing that just like in this style of content that like immediately signals is like a dog whistle, like a frequency that only 12-year-olds can comprehend, where they just immediately go, oh, I'm supposed to stand.
Yeah,
where they're like programmed.
I think it's literally like what happened to you when you were a kid on a bigger level, where they see this this niche or this group that seems to them like it's unique and special. And so they like want to get into it and be as big, like the biggest person who's into that.
See, we already have some stands in here. This is Betty Chan. That's fucked up, Weeby.
Betty Chan.
I think a lot of people online self-insert as the other two, and they consider that one to be the bitch that managed them while they were kids. Yeah,
exactly. That's exactly what it is.
A lot of personal biases factor into like the way we analyze content on the internet, for sure. Something I talk about regularly here. I feel like the AC... what the fuck? Bro, my mom... Jesus Christ.
Change it to heat. She I have the same exact app thing on my phone.
Yeah, she loves just turning off the AC very subtly too. Like without
I didn't realize.
She's like, oops, is the AC turned off? Didn't know how that happened. And it's like, come on, it's so hot. It's gonna take 2 hours to fucking get cold again. Meanwhile, the top of the hour ad break is here, and all of you are going to see those ads unless you subscribe for $5 or for free with the Twitch Prime by connecting your Amazon Prime account to your Twitch account, where you get one free Prime subscription a month, or by getting gifted the sub. Here's a 3-minute ad break now. Okay, based Eco Warrior. Yeah, except Kaya will die, okay? How about that, you fucking assholes? She's a Tibetan massive. She needs to be in the cool.
She'll die.
Yeah. Well, she will. She does overheat. She does have a tendency to overheat a little bit. Aren't they the cutest?
Oh, I gotta watch the video where they're actually performing.
Bro, they're so bad. What the fuck? They can't even sync up. Yo, what is that? Why am I also like arguing about this? Not on like the cultural appropriation component or whatever, just but on like on just like their dance moves are not like.
There's a video on this page of them performing on a stage. You can tell that the stage is like crowd's empty because they're like behind the barricade. But they did perform at an anime expo in LA. Go to their page. I'll show you the clip from it. Actually, I think today is. Wait, you need to look up if today might be the actual expo they were gonna perform at before this happened.
Wait, the anime expo is happening right now?
I think it might be today, like in. You gotta look it up.
They were supposed to perform today? Wait, where is it? What am I looking at to see? Oh, is this the stage one?
Yeah, yeah.
Wait, why is it just Alice and Barry? Where's the other one?
I don't know.
Okay, like, I am not exactly initiated, and I don't really know. I don't know any of this shit, right? But, like, I don't think that they're doing a good job with the dance move. Are they doing a good job, chat? You guys are a bunch of fucking K-pop stan freaks in here. Come on, explain this to me. Is this good? No, right? It doesn't feel good. It feels clunky.
The choreography's clunky.
No, it's just so, it's making me mad. Like,
it's so funny because you'll say so many things that are, like, foreshadowing what things that I'm going to show you.
We are two members of Sorbet. One of our members, Ash, was not able to make it, but I'm Alice. Mrs. Barry thought we would bring some of our favorite dance covers to Innifest. I'll go ahead and start with mine. I'm going to say, lucky, lucky, and then all of us together say, Alice! Are you ready? Lucky.
There's a lot of people. They said it. Okay,
shit.
This is brainwashing. Why are conservatives worried about, like, how our children are wearing rainbow flags or whatever? They should be worried about this, dude. They should be fucking worried about the stranglehold that even shitty versions of K-pop have on our children. You know what I mean? What the hell? J-pop dancing is way worse than K-pop. It's not even comparable. I don't know. I don't know anything.
There's also no way that the J-pop stars dance anything like that.
Yeah. Like, are they just bad because it's J-pop supposedly? I didn't think it could get worse than these guys. What's up? Yo, don't put them on K-pop. What the fuck?
Thank you. Hello. My name is Barry. I call and respond.
That Annafest 2020.
So I'm going to say stop.
Oh, God.
Oh, she's doing it again. She's doing it again in front of a big crowd. Oh, brave of her. I I do my Japanese English all the time, and I did it in front of Japanese people too regularly. So actually, it's not even weird to do that in Japan, because it's just loner words that they have decided is how you're supposed to say it. But anyway, whatever. Let's just listen. Why is she everyone's favorite? Like, no, you're not my favorite, Barry-chan. What the fuck?
There's two other people in.
Yeah, what the fuck is this? Like, why is her? First of all, why is her call sign in Japanese? Aren't they supposed to be a K-pop group?
Oh, you'll see.
Secondly, why is she the leader? Why? Who made you? Who died and made you the fucking everyone's favorite idol? You are not my favorite idol, Barry-chan.
We are Ash. Ash stands.
No, this is J-pop, you goober. Wait, I thought the other ones were doing K-pop.
No, the other ones just do English.
Well, I mean, they're not even doing... Oh, so they are the actually songs, emulating...
I think the songs are... At least this song, I went on another thing with this 50-50 group who is a J-pop, like, female idol group. It's a lot different than this. Okay, I think you need to watch the...
You obviously know nothing about idol groups. Yeah, man! I'm a 31-year-old, about to be 32-year-old ass adult motherfucker. Of course I don't know shit about idol groups. What kind of own do you think this is? you need to be stuffed into a fucking locker, you goober. What the hell? Only on Twitch, a platform that has cultivated this, like, this weird, distorted fucking hierarchy where some fucking nerd could come in here and be like, you don't know shit about idol groups, you fucking idiot.
Obviously don't know anything.
I'm gonna die tomorrow. Like, that's how old I am. Fuck you.
I
mean,
I didn't even know what the term idol group, like, I didn't know that was a term people used, especially overseas idol groups, which we'll also save for after the apology.
Arigato. Wait, I gotta
okay, I need to see the hashtag Anifest 2023. Wait, is there a... God, I don't know how to use this. I don't know if I'm going to, like, dox him on accident. What day is it today? Oh, I don't. Mouse just stop. Where? Oh. Do I do desktop now or the camera? Where they were talking about this LA anime expo that they were gonna be at. Wait, I can find it if I go to their TikTok. Sunday, May 21st. Oh, that was last week. So we missed it. Sunday, May 21st was...
No!
Yeah.
No, we missed it!
I mean, there's another one in June 30th.
But wait, hold on. What do you mean we missed it? Like, does that mean that, like, they're going to be at that? Or are you just looking at, like, Anime Expo?
I have a feeling that, no, I don't know what they're going to be at. But I don't know if they'd show up. I think Barry is now on, like, the watch list. Auntie.
Oh my God. Auntie Piker. Auntie hashtag Stan Sorbet.
This is awesome.
Oh, good one. Good one, Auntie Piker. I'm missing so much context. Yeah. Do you wonder if their road to popularity is the cringe?
Oh, it was. Yeah.
I think that is going to happen, but I don't think they're like, they did it deliberately. I think it was unintentional that they were.
Yeah, they posted it, and I'm guessing that it was like three friends who did not think they were going to be like the stars of some news
There's
story.
Something like it. Okay, you know what it's giving?
What is it giving?
Okay, see, I'm already doing K-pop stand speak. It's giving
what is it?
Rich suburban, you know, parents that like want to make this happen. It seems like one of their parents. I'm making this entire thing up, but in my mind, when I look at something like this, it tracks like one of their family members is like very rich. Which one of them? The Barry, I think probably.
It's gotta be Barry.
Most likely. Is the one who has like rich parents who's like funding and facilitating this. They're all friends. They grew up together and they are trying to, you know, they're just trying to keep them busy.
My
parents are.
My fear and something that happens in some of these cases is that these people, which also may be true here, is that these people might be full grown adults. I almost think they are.
Oh, they're not children. I don't think they're children. I mean, she has like a fucking fat leg tattoo and shit. Like,
fat leg.
I mean, I'm just saying. Like, I don't think that. I don't think she's like young.
They got to be in their 20s.
Yeah, they're not like 14. What I mean.
You see the crowd reaction.
They're industry plants. What industry, dog? You think this is an industry plant? Like, Billie Eilish is like where you can make that argument. Like. You know how manicured industry plants are? You have no understanding of industry plants if you think that like these guys are industry plants, unless you're talking about the industry of cringe, okay? the multi-billion dollar like the multi-billion dollar record label industry could not produce three more talented lip syncers than these three, okay? What the fuck? Their industry pesticides. So much salad. She's just trying to eat all the salad that you spilled. Yeah. Kaya is an industry plant. Industry of cuteness.
Oh, yeah.
I knew Ash. They're all in their late 20s. This is super common in the SoCal cosplay community. Basically, they find each other on Twitter, Instagram, and meet up make these groups. They don't know each other.
I could also... That? I am...
They should do an arc where they get drafted like BTS.
Oh my God, he just like...
Oh, she is like... Yeah, she dabs. She'll dab you up. She'll go, hey, look at this. She got big ass paws too. She'll be like, yo, what's up? Yo, what's up?
Who is this?
Dog. Hey. Okay. So let's watch some more of this cringe though, because it's fucking awesome. So we saw this already.
Oh wait, this isn't the clip. Go to the.
Wait, they have an original song? No fucking way they sing.
Those mics are on. Yeah, this one they had an outfit change for the two performances, so you can let us know which one you think is better. This one.
Wait, they're furries too? I guess that's like common. Okay.
And they think the mics are just, the mics are just props for them to.
Wait, so when they say, like, we have an original song, they mean, like, they're not actually singing it. They're just, like, they have a new dance. Whoa. Downtown LA photo shoot. Random tourists happening upon our photo shoot.
Whoa.
Right.
Wait, where are the random tourists?
Bro. Yeah. Whoa.
Did that guy?
What? Wait, I don't get it.
I think it's the sound. They're trying to do something with the...
It's a POV. Oh, okay.
This is also another song. This is like a super popular J-pop girl group that I learned about yesterday.
I know that this is not their song, Nick. What the fuck?
What,
do you
I didn't
mean?
Know. I thought you didn't listen
Wait,
to music.
You watched this and you were like, wow, no, what a productional rendition. Like, oh my God.
No, I did not think that.
And it's not J-pop, it's K-pop. You are literally about to get canceled.
No, that group, 50-50. Wait, I don't. Is 50-50 K-pop?
No, this song is K-pop, dude. What the fuck? How do you not know this?
I'm the TikTok guy. I'm not the K-pop.
You're the
guy.
Zoomer guy. What the fuck? You also, look, I'm a boomer, but also. Yeah, hashtag Nick is over party is like happening right now. They are eating your ass in the QRTs.
Listen, I was just saying that they're performing.
Someone said literally the most racist man alive. No one has been more racist than you.
That's facts. Not even on just on the stream.
Yeah, 100%. Not me, though. I know that it's K-pop. Please don't kill me.
Okay, apology time. I need to see this.
Okay.
Changes everything.
I mean, this bangs a little bit. Nick is not racist. Yeah, exactly.
Guys, come on.
Okay, so...
funny about racism.
So... This happened. Okay, so they're like, I don't know. They got, wait, why'd they have one fit? They're always wearing the same fucking fit. Dude, these are getting a lot of views, bro.
Yeah, it all happened like, I think these views are literally just people going back through their old shit after.
And they're like standing them though. Like they're standing individuals now.
Oh yeah.
We got K-pop at home. K-pop at home. That's funny.
Asian one can be a mom in any movies.
This person said they would have been so successful if they made English pop.
No shot.
That's just pop. That's pop. You're just describing pop music.
Also, this has 500 likes. There's no way they would have been. There's just no way they would have been successful if they made English pop. They're not making it.
Yeah.
Also, I think they were trying to do English pop. Like, I think their music was gonna be in English. Only her solo stuff was going to be in Japanese.
Yeah, see, this is, I actually just stan Allison Ash. So everybody hates Barry, but they're also like either fake stanning or like real stanning the other two, which also is weird to me. Like, why? Are you that desperate? Is there not enough perfectly manicured like Japanese and Korean pop idols out there that you like had to... Like, anytime you see a new one, you're like, no, 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 this is a formation, and my brain only works this way. Immediately, I have to stand one of them. What's your bias? What's your fave? What's your problematic fave? What's your bias? It's like, I don't think Barry is equipped to be hated as much. Yeah, I know.
No, of course not. Well, it's crazy, because if you look through, like, especially as you get closer to the newest ones, it's just like, it's not even like some people are picking to, like, side with this person, that person. It's just like, their comments are... Barry sucks, and she forced these two girls who are her friends into this, and she's a criminal.
She's a criminal. Yeah, that's very normal. That's a very normal way to analyze just your regular daily shit. I don't, this is how it's done, right? And it's really fire.
Oh, yeah, here's your comparison.
Okay, but this is actually good.
And they're probably,
like, that's actually good. You're just showing, like a good version of, like, fan-made dances. I don't even know if it's professional or not, but, like. Okay, this is.
Stay with me.
He was like reading it in
How are you supposed to do?
Yeah, it was really fucked up. Creating fake drama between group members is a good way to get publicity. TikTok hates you. Oh my fucking God. Wait, why? Where did that come from?
TikTok hates you, man.
Best Barry dance.
Oh,
What is happening here?
I did not think you and I were going to be watching this today.
Why can't I stop watching this? What's happening? She streams on Twitch. It's so good to watch. Oh, no. He said she streams on Twitch, so it's good to watch. Okay.
So it's so good.
Yeah, I thought he was like,
it's so good to watch.
So good to watch. Look at Kaya trying to get Fiona's attention and failing to do so. Yeah, she hates her. She fucking hates how annoying she gets. Okay, sorry. You are not seeing the kingdom of heaven. I mean, yeah, but it's fine. So this is a Twitch streamer. Barry is a Twitch streamer. We're not gonna finish that video. We gotta get back on track, okay? Yeah. We have to get back on track. And so this is Sorbet. People making fun of them, but who's happier? They're just enjoying life shamelessly. Why is the green one always left out? I just want to live. Me, I want to be called Deluxe. Loud the outfits. We want an Alice and Ash duo. Like, they're... Okay, let's watch the apology video. Fuck it.
Yes.
Let's watch the fucking apology video. It's up here. This is it.
Yeah.
Hey, everyone. This is Barry. I just wanted to hop on really quick and address my...
Also, way different voice than the one she was using in the...
Yeah, it would have been way funnier if she was like... if she was like, it's Betty Chan. But also, like, even in the apology video, calling yourself Barry is pretty funny.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Hey, guys, it's Barry.
Food. Response in Sorbet's latest TikTok video. So first off, I just want to start out by saying that I genuinely and wholeheartedly apologize to every single person that I have upset or that I have offended with my call and response. I truly did not have any ill intent, but I also understand that.
Yo, she went Burbank real quick. It's like, so this is funny. She is no longer giving Betty Chan. She's giving Burbank. Okay, this is.
She's like, "What's up, guys? It's Barry."
Yeah, I really
it's
fucked
so
up.
Funny.
Yeah. When I said Betty Chan, I meant Barry, like Barry.
Show.
I have hurt a lot of people. And for that, I am sorry. I, as a white person, have an insane amount of privilege. And I will never truly understand the struggles that people...
It's true. Why are you laughing? Racist? She's acknowledging it. She's acknowledging her privilege. Yeah, racist?
There's something so funny about someone going, I have an insane amount of white privilege.
I like to think about, like, when she does stuff like that, why is she flexing though?
She's like, you gotta use it. I mean,
yeah. No, what I do think is like really funny about this is that like they're just cringe. Like they didn't do anything illegal. They didn't even do anything hateful. Let's be fucking real. Like, yeah, it's like cultural appropriation, but like it's so cringe that it's not like, they're not. I don't know. I don't know how to describe it. Like they're not exactly like who are they hurting? Like who,
yeah, their actions
who did,
aren't affecting.
Who did Betty Chan hurt? Okay. Explain to me how she did the hurt and who she hurted, okay? Who she hurted.
It was literally just the only pain people felt from this was just cringe. It wasn't like, oh my god, yeah. What a steaming racist.
Yeah, they're not doing Bodies in Spaces. They're not taking the space of an Asian idol group. You know what I mean? Like, there's no, like, the skill level is so high for them to, like, they're never seeing that, okay? That's never happening.
No, you have to be made in, like, a factory to become one of those, to become as popular.
Yeah, those little girls are starting off at the age of, like, fucking 12, okay?
Brainwashed. They're, like, literally robots.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Let's see what...
And I did not mean to amount of privilege. And I will never truly understand the struggles that people of color go through. And I did not mean to undermine or ignore or disregard any of those struggles. And I am sorry. Now, I did want to give some background on my call and response and explain why it was the way it was. The reason why my call and response is in Japanese despite Sorbet releasing music in English.
Wait, they're releasing
music? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. They don't do anything. They don't do
Nick,
anything.
They've released music in English?
I think by releasing, she means we are going to. I don't know if they have actually released
Nick, music. You are the worst journalist. I'm going to say
it. I'm right. I told you from the beginning.
Chat, someone find me.
They didn't release the song yet. They couldn't have. If I'm wrong, I'll be so.
She's making it seem like they're releasing music. They need to. There's already a Know Your Meme page about it.
This literally happened. When did she post? She posted this literally yesterday morning.
Bro, read the third comment. I'm disappointed she didn't say I'm very sorry. Okay, but like. Nick is truly a Zoomer correspondent.
I'm like losing my job, my new job. This is the first day.
Wait, okay. Someone explain to me what like they have to be. There has to be music,
dude. No,
it's all right, dude. She made a severe lapse on her judgment, a severe and continued lapse of judgment.
Like, when I eventually have my own tracks, I plan to release solo music almost exclusively in Japanese. And I figured that since I'm the same person, whether I'm
in Japanese.
Wait.
This is crazy. This part's wild to me.
Wait, I'm confused by all of the things that she's saying. Like, there is no English music as Sorbet, as far as we know. And she's already, like, talking about her solo ambitions. But you guys never even release music as a trio. Where's the music?
The apology is so funny because they did not release a single song. But she is planning on not only releasing music with Sorbet as English music and an idol group, so none of it is really Japanese at all, and then also wants to release solo music as Barry, which will almost exclusively be in Japanese.
Why does she look Asian in her dance video, please? I feel insane. She did not. She never looked Asian.
Oh, no. No one ever thought she was Asian.
Was there a moment where any of you guys thought she was Asian?
I think people had criticisms because of how much she was squinting her eyes was a comments that I saw where people were like, why is she squinting her eyes so much? And I get how the makeup and the way she does it could come off as like she's
I mean the Asian. Outfit and stuff, like she's definitely trying to appear some type of way, but I don't think she's I just never from down the street. Yeah. Yeah, if you were like just looking at her like Japanese schoolgirl outfit from like, you know, 500 yards or something, maybe you could be like like what? I saw her squinting. Shut the fuck up. No, I don't.
That's so fucked. Okay, this is the best part.
Yeah.
I have my own tracks. I plan to release solo music almost exclusively in Japanese. And I figured that since I'm the same person, whether I'm solo or in a group, that I could use the same call and response in both instances. Also, my boyfriend, who is Japanese, unintentionally came up with part of my call and response.
You did not expect her to pull that card.
Oh, yeah, dude. Fuck yeah. Okay, this is fire because, like it's not even all... I mean, I don't even think this is fucking problematic. It's just, like, so cringe.
It's so funny.
I know that some people are going to get mad at me and say, like, Hassan, you're fucking... You don't understand. Like, you're not Korean or Japanese. You don't get it. Like, it is actually problematic or whatever. But now it is becoming that almost where like she's like there's like a fetishization angle now.
Oh, don't pet them while they're misbehaving.
Oh, is she?
Yeah, well, she's just being fucking annoying, and
Fiona is
no, that's good. That's why I put them in there.
Oh, okay.
Because I want Fiona to check her behavior, to regulate her behavior.
Tame the beast.
You are not Japanese. That's what you think. Call and response is a cultural touch point. She looks like the... Wait, what? Okay. Buddy, you're going to be sorry if you missed their reunion tour.
The reunion tour that is...
I just don't get why like she had to make... She thought that she felt the need to make this... But then, like, now her apology is, like, fucking worse. You know what I mean?
So funny.
What's funny is Kaya fucking laying next to Fiona and just barking in her face.
Right in her face.
To try to get her attention and just not getting a single...
Oh, my God.
She is so stupid.
So great. Hey.
Okay.
One day we were just talking about my idol career, and on a whim he just made up
that
something.
That part's crazy too. You gotta back that one.
Wait, you guys were talking about your idol career?
The way she says it too, like.
Like, does she actually think she's an idol? Like, what's happening?
Wait, like, listen to the way she says idol career. It's wild.
Yo, you want to see Fiona popping off on Kaya from yesterday? This is pretty funny.
We're going to double the barks.
But they had to chop it.
Oh, my God. She got swung at.
Yeah, she fucking... she got dodges. Scared and launched her entire body away from her. Look, that they had to chop it.
She didn't even get pushed. She just, like,
yeah.
went out.
And then her arm got stuck in the door. Like...
Out. She's pulling the bully stick out. Uh-oh. Fucking end that shit real quick.
Now she's going to try to get attention from you, Nick, because you gave the little baby a crumb of attention when she was looking for it. Pre-debut idol. I'm going to make it one day. Also, yeah, someone in the chat already mentioned this, but she just admitted to having a boyfriend, which is like the worst thing you can do as an idol, I feel like. Yeah, so like it's over for you.
It's like the next step up from Twitch streamers.
I just wanted to hop on really quick and address my...
So let's finish this, okay?
Because I'm all about the...
So she's like talking about her idol career. Fuck.
Yeah, that part is so funny. She's like, one day we were just talking about my idol career.
In Japanese. And I figured that since I'm the same person, whether I'm solo or in a group... that I could use the same call and response in both instances. Also, my boyfriend, who is Japanese, unintentionally came up with
By
part
the
of
way.
My call and response. One day, we were just talking about my idol career, and on a whim, he just made up something. And I ended up wanting to incorporate it because I'm all about the strawberry aesthetic and my online...
this.
Kaya, enough. Enough. What are you doing? I'm going to bring you upstairs.
She's going to go in timeout.
Be normal.
Be normal.
Fucking weirdo.
Alias is associated with blueberries, so I thought that it was perfect for me. I thought that since my call and response is in Japanese... that if I pronounced the words strawberry and blueberry the way that the katakana would be read out loud, that it would be okay. And I see now
strawberry.
That...
Strawberry!
I mean, that is how you read it, yeah. Blueberry!
But I was wrong.
Such a wild...
I've already got another call and response picked up.
Oh! She hit it! Hit or miss, baby! I guess she wouldn't miss that one.
That was
fuck awesome. Yes, dude. She hit the fucking boom!
Jump scare I got from that.
Yo, she's every good time. She had to do it to him. She just came up like,
sorry, I was racist.
Which, yeah. Dude, I love this. Okay, this is awesome. This is great because the stakes are so low. It's like,
right?
It's
this
awesome.
Is like the perfect one.
Yeah, this is great.
But this will be the next. I'm guessing this is gonna... I'm still gonna make this into a second channel video, so you might have to re...
Yeah, we'll re-experience the cringe.
While I clip through.
I've already got another call and response picked out for Saturday. What's a call and response?
The call and response is the thing where...
Oh, no! No, that's
this
real.
This is
I did
taking
that.
Over for Betty Chan.
I did do that. Yeah. Blue Betty Chan.
We have a new leader.
Yeah. Yeah, that's me being my best self. Blue
yeah,
Betty Chan.
Awesome.
So... what's a call and response?
Call and response is like their little character, like...
Hi, guys.
Oh, so this...
there's more.
I watched this yesterday, too, but it just makes me feel bad because Ash, she does seem like a nice person. I mean, they all probably are nice people in real life. Like, it's just... they have, like, a fixation.
See,
on...
you've already... you've literally already, like,
already
adopted the... You've already adopted the stance that TikTok has that Barry is bad. Barry-chan is bad.
God.
With part of my call and response. One day we were just talking about my idol career and on a whim he just made up something and I apologize. Thank you. And I see now that I was
Wait,
in
so
Japanese that if I pronounced the words strawberry and blueberry the way that the katakana would.
So, but what I don't understand is, like, if you're apologizing for it, then, like, does that mean you're done? It's over? You're never going to be an idol? Like, what the fuck's happening? Because, like, the entire concept of you wanting to be an idol implies that you're going to keep doing this, right?
Yeah.
Which, by the way, she should. For the sake of content, for all of us, I would like to say I'm lending my full support behind this initiative, this movement. Betty-chan, keep leaning into it, okay?
Yeah, I fully want to be back next week with her.
Because, like, so, because if she apologizes for it, like, then she leaves it, like, halfway. So she's still doing, like, J-pop idol shit, but, like, doing it in English. Like, no more katakana. Like, what the fuck's going on there?
Yeah, I don't know.
For chatters wanting to know what a call and response looks like for real, I guess this.
Oh, so this is, like, title group.
Wait, what is this? Are they supposed to be this? Like, are they?
I have no idea.
Are these the characters, like the animated versions of these people? Is that what it is, or vice versa? Like, what's happening? Yeah, the good thing the subtitles are there to explain to us what's going on.
I know, I'm just looking at it with so much confusion. Like, there's too much on the screen.
There's a crowd of male voices. Oh, yeah.
Betty-chan! That is like... That is so many people.
It's not just a K-pop or J-pop thing.
Okay, this is like not what they. This is
what Peruvian music. No, what is like happening?
Call this and response. This is like a music theory term. Like,
dude, you just turned this into like every other TikTok, not, which is like actually this is very problematic because it comes from like enslaved populations, like the root of call and response. No, like
fucking call and response is like. Trying to think of a regular American-ass song.
I don't think this is what they're doing.
It's not like a character thing in America. It's just a thing that happens in songs where people chant stuff. So, yeah, that's kind of the...
They are VAs who are performing the role of the 2D character in anime and games. Oh, okay. That makes sense. Every dadless Andrew Tate stan is in that room. Here's Queen doing it.
Yeah, I know. That's not the same. That's like... This is not is the like, same as a J-pop call and response. That's for like a character. Like you're in a video game or something. This is just him singing and them singing back.
They do call and response in the army when doing marching drills.
It's just... You guys are just using the term call and response.
Okay. Like, still an English US thing, just a very common characteristic brand of J-pop music.
This is just, that's call and response when we're like repeating it. The Barry-chan thing is not like, they're not saying what she's saying back. Like they're saying it at first, but then she's doing the whole thing and then they're all chanting. It's like a whole rehearsed thing.
When I call girls, they don't respond. That's a good one, Chatter. The call song says Sweet Caroline, and the response is the crowd going, okay, like, I get it, but that's in a song.
It's also still different than, like...
This is, like, but like, when they do it, I feel like when they do it in K-pop, J-pop, whatever, like, I think it's more so, it seems like it's, like a call sign that, like, you're doing, like, an interactive call sign. It's not a musical call and response. It's just, like, they say something, and then the crowd responds in a similar fashion. But it's not supposed to be in the song. It's like a catchphrase.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, I'm getting it. I'm learning so much today.
No, this is really like...
Yeah, okay, so let's see what Ash had to say.
Ash here. I never thought I'd be making a video like this on my own.
Like, no one who has a phone camera like this should be ever known by this many people and canceled.
Yeah, some kind of freakish droid. From
yeah, if you have like an Android, if you have like an Android 8, okay? Like, you do not deserve to be known by this many people and canceled, okay? Like, no one should have a negative reaction to your existence on the internet because you are not cut out for this, okay?
Also, like, nobody, if you look at the comments of this one, everyone's like, oh, you're fine. Like, why are you apologizing?
What the fuck is an Android 8? I don't know. How many Androids are out there? Okay, an Android 8? Shut up. I have an iPhone. Android 1. That's
just throw a number on the end there.
So Matt Healy got canceled for his call and response, too? So, like, Matt Healy is, that's valid to get upset at Matt Healy because he's, like, actually a famous person, okay? I mean, even then, people go overboard and they're ridiculous, but, like, this person is just a guy, a lady. You know what I mean? Like a person. Just a normal person. Like possibly a CPA, okay? You're just fucking... You're just getting mad at a person just like you in that situation.
Talk, but I like to address the whole Sorbet situation from my perspective. Also, apologies in advance. I'm looking at a script right now, so I can, like, mention everything that needs to be said. So if you see me looking off camera or a little bit to the side, it's because I'm reading off everything. First, I'd like to show my thanks and my appreciation for all the support we've been given. I never thought that our video would garner this kind of reaction in the first place. Now, I just want to touch base about us as a group. I understand and hear all the criticism we've been receiving about our performance and our talents as an idol group. All the original work we do.
It's so weird that they're talking about this like this is an established group.
Yeah,
like there's money behind this.
Is from our own hands, and I'm like,
what original work are they talking about? Like, what is... What the fuck is happening here?
Who is from our very own hands, and we do plan to release more with your continued support. And I
what are they releasing?
That aren't the I'm best that you. There is. We are most definitely trying, and I know we will continue to grow and learn with each new experience. Now, regarding the solo stuff and my cosplay accounts and such, I don't ever really plan on really? Solo. I do occasionally release YouTube song covers and on Instagram as well every now and then, but that's mostly it. And as much as there are people who support us, I know there are also people who don't, and I'm not gonna make the effort to continue to reach out for them in hopes of anything. But in regards to that, I would
can't wait for the next fear and okay, calm down everybody.
You're Betty Chan.
I can't believe they made me Betty Chan, bro. I'm not Betty Chan, okay?
You're such a Betty Chan dude. Actually, you're more of an Ash, I feel like.
Yeah.
I would like to keep my cosplay content and my Sorbet content completely separate. If you want to support me as Ash in Sorbet, then please do so because of my efforts in Sorbet. But if you want to support Ash, as in Tokyo Ash, for my cosplay content, then please do so there. I'd like to keep those...
Yeah, you hate that. You got to separate those two. You know what,
like,
I mean?
Well, she's like, I don't want... Because... Basically, her page is just like a cosplay page, and now suddenly she's like having to apologize for being the only Asian member in the group.
Yeah, the one that's getting cut first.
Yeah, and she's not even in half the performances.
Yeah,
she's separate, and I've never really wanted them to cross over. And I know I've garnered some criticism because of my call and response as well, because it is in Japanese. And I just want to say that because I've only ever learned Richi Mahjong, I've decided that it is only appropriate to use the correct terms. And I understand that Mahjong is definitely originally a Chinese game, but there's a vast number of differences between Japanese and Chinese Mahjong. Now, I've also had some questions regarding as to what kind of Asian I am. It really doesn't matter. I wish to withhold that information.
Max Queen.
Damn! She said,
isn't that crazy, though?
Figure it out.
The way she said that, I was like, okay, that's kind of awesome. Just like, it doesn't matter what kind of Asian I am.
Respect.
It is true. Like,
respect.
You're in a group with two other white girls, so it still doesn't matter.
Respect. I still, I kind of want to know, but, you know, whatever.
I kind of want to know.
Like, what kind of Asian? You know she's explaining this to white people. Did you ever bother playing Mahjong in Yakuza? I sure as fuck didn't. No, I did not play Mahjong in Yakuza.
I played in Club Penguin when I was like in elementary school.
Pookie, it's just Barry Chan. You and Alice are on top.
Look,
what?
Look at these comments. This
it's
is crazy.
Not you. It's Barry Queen. Stop. You didn't do anything wrong. Sis, you don't have to apologize at all. Like, you're 100% good. Your call, amazing. Your response eats every time.
Like,
we love
what
you.
The fuck?
And she like put the fucking call sign in there too. The Mahjong call-out is cool as hell, by the way. You're cool. I like Mahjong concept. It's just Barry. Ash is my bias. What is going on?
It doesn't stop. It's every single one. Look.
But just this is not every real. Single one. But this is not like she shouldn't be apologizing, but like neither should fucking Barry. Like, what is happening?
She has a Japanese boyfriend.
Yeah, that's times? Why. I'm so fucking confused as to why like there is even any like real drama.
So funny.
And it makes no sense. From what I've gathered, you are fine and aren't the problem. It's Barry.
Yeah, I don't know. It's like, it's weird. It's like she's doing that stuff. It's not like they found out Barry did something behind closed doors so the other members are okay. It's
yeah.
Like you were in the video when it happened.
I don't know what the fuck is happening here. Like, so what's the angle? Can someone who's like K-pop obsessed explain to me what the fucking like what the controversy is even? Because like, Hassan, the internet loves a niche inside joke. It's inside meme, so people go all the way with it. Like, you think people are like genuinely standing this person, or do you think they're just like memeing?
I personally genuinely believe that the people who are commenting on these videos are I think they genuinely do like the other two girls and think because they're like more reserved and shy and they didn't like say something in English in like a weird Japanese accent. Then I think like in your brain, TikTok will. This is into the fence.
This fucking guy. That's the point of the controversy, and it is surprising. Is what this person said, and they linked this to me. They fucking debated me. God damn it.
No, it really is like TikTok will make their like hero and villain, and then everyone has like something to say about it. Oh my god.
Jabuki's getting in on it. Oh no.
Hello, Ash.
Pon Pon Con Con Sumo. It's her victory. Yup.
Look, this is like wild.
I think this is yet another instance where, like, people are doing this ironically, and then it turns into unironically.
Yeah, totally.
How's going to be correlating K-pop and J-pop as if they aren't different countries? Yes, I'm doing it on purpose because I'm racist, okay? You caught me. And not because, like, these white ladies from California have just, like, made a mishmash of different idol cultures, which even includes like some Chinese elements in it as well. And it's certainly my fault. It's me. I'm the problem. It's me. Okay.
And also the fact that their music is 100% in English. So what's the difference? It's just regular pop music. You're just making pop music.
It's not originally sourced, so the fans don't fuck with it. But like, what? It's not
originally sourced.
I think what's happening here is, well, one, the top of the hour ad break is happening here, which is, this is the last story. Like, I don't want to keep Nick hostage here.
I'm burning out.
And if you no longer want to see those ads, all you need to do is subscribe, which you can do for $5 or for free with a Twitch Prime. But here's the 3-minute ad break now. Okay. But like, this just strikes me as like a group of people that are just like fucking around and then like, and then now it's like, again, yet another instance where like it went viral because it was like super cringe, and cringe is illegal.
Yeah, and then someone just does this.
Who would do that in public? Ew. I would never do that in public. If you ever caught me doing that in public, that's not me. It's a deep fake.
The link's going to pop up in like...
No, I would never do that. You can't find me doing that.
Wow. My God, that guy's so tall. What the fuck?
I know. So, this is Tokyo Ash.
Like, nobody who has a cosplay account with 3,000 followers should have to make any statement on
anything. They're literally filming all their shit from, like... She's filming everything from her, like, you know, Android One. What is this? What is this link? What? It's not.
What is that?
I don't know what this is. This is a deepfake, I think. It's not me. Like, clearly, I've never...
Is this AI?
Yeah, no, well, this is not my apartment. As you can see, I have a house, so I'm a house owner.
And that dog is, like, not...
Yeah, it's a different dog. I don't know what's going on there.
Yeah, me too.
Are you Naruto running? You just Naruto ran, bro.
Wait, did you get a picture of that?
No, I fucking missed it. Do it again.
You won't even do it long enough to get captured.
Yeah. Well, you got caught on camera. And that's what he did.
Okay, I have one. I have a closing note on this video that is going. I need to explain before you watch the link.
You guys want to do a Naruto run,
dude? I guess only. Oh,
who's that guy? Who is this guy? He's got long hair. He seems like a very handsome guy. Who probably smells really good.
Look at him go!
Oh my God. I don't know who this guy is, but like he seems like a cool guy.
Really hard for you not to body check someone on accident doing that.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck there what's happening here. This is you, bro. What?
No balls. You won't do a Naruto run, bitch. I'll fucking Naruto run right now. Don't ask me things. I
didn't realize you had like a wide cam.
I don't. It's not connected to my computer.
That's great.
Take your keys.
Are you going to the Anime Expo this year?
Maybe.
Me if you did.
Okay, so this last link I clicked on the hashtag. It should be the last one, the Sorbet one, but don't. I saw this comment, which I thought was very funny after watching the video, but I want to say there's another overseas idol group. Not called Sorbet, but called Ice Cream. And I, before anyone says anything, I think that in a lot of cases, people who are in idol groups, in America at least, happen to be potentially groups of neurodivergent adults.
Okay, they're friends, I think. They're not like an actual idol group or something.
It's sort of like, but this is like... A Canadian J-pop inspired.
This guy's you, but white.
What is he talking about?
I don't know. He just looks like
freak.
Bro.
This is Nick is not white.
That's my
I don't know why I just saw that. I don't know why you're getting the call outs today. Wait, where the fuck did he go? Oh fuck, I lost it. Okay, I gotta reopen that link. Okay, let's see. This is a Canadian J-pop group.
And they do very much like the same thing.
Yeah, I think these are just people having fun. Like, so, I don't think this is like serious.
So this is like, then I scroll down and look at the comments. This is literally, this one is just like.
Ate that up.
It's just people dancing to music. And it, the comment, oh, what the fuck? The one I screenshotted has 88 likes, and he says...
At least be able to synchronize, goddamn, bruh. The fuck y'all a group for?
I was like, dude, they're like...
I mean, yeah, they're just like friends.
Just, like, I think this one caught strays because of Betty-chan getting...
Oh my God. Our members, when they realize they have a day off after a big weekend of practices, what are they practicing? No. No. They should practice more. They should not be taking a weekend off. Okay?
I legitimately just think it's like these adults that have a very big fixation on anime and like Japanese culture and but don't realize that what they're doing is just dancing when you play it, when you do it to original. The synchronized dancing.
What? They have matching outfits already better than Sorbet? Is that the Barry? She's the Barry of the group.
What happened to you?
She just realized when the cringe hits. Just
it happened like halfway through it. Like, she just like... Does...
This is the autism Fulcrum was talking about visibly.
No!
It's fucked up. No, I disavow that.
It's
comment.
Been a great time being here. I think on that note, I just am gonna
see. This is how this becomes ableist. People are saying in the chat, autistic, not normal.
That's why I gave my precursor for everybody.
Okay. Okay. Listen to me. Okay, Fulcrum, come in. Yup. Okay. So.
What did we learn?
Let them practice. They this close to the regionals. Wait, there's like. So I don't get it. Like, so these are just like, is this like a bunch of people having fun with friends, or is this like something serious?
What I get confused about, because they brand it as an idol group.
Like they have official in the name, and it's Ice Cream.
I'm assuming because they live in Quebec, because they're French Canadian.
Oh, that's a big L. Okay, that's like L number one, dude. Oh, holy shit!
There's their calls, and keep in mind when you watch
okay,
these
that,
calls.
Okay, that actually explains a lot that they're like that they're from Quebec.
That's the other thing is they. What he's trying to say?
Yeah, no, they're Quebecois. That's yeah, let him have this. You know what I mean?
So when they do their call outs, just so the random chatter understands. They have French accents.
See, Emhud, leave these gals alone. Anyone from Quebec that is not playing competitive online games, improving gaming as a whole. True. True. What is this?
Fashion!
Okay!
Fashion!
Hi, I'm Lara. I'm the Vermilion Cherry member of Ice Cream. I may be cold, but I hope I will warm your heart.
I don't... I just don't know what's going on. Like I'm,
and they have a show at Nadeshikon in 24th. What is that?
Nadeshikon?
That already happened.
Yeah, comments are turned off.
Ice Sprinkle, my name is Sam. I'm the yellow citrus member of.
Wait, her name is Sam. Wait, I want to know. I think she's French. She's Francophone.
I'm the yellow citrus member of Ice Cream. When life gives you some, you may.
I watched this yesterday, and when they started talking, my heart was like, "Oh my god!" Like, why are they? And then I realized they're just Canadians.
Yeah, they're just Francophones, bro. That's like wrong. That's what I'm telling you. Like, they're allowed to do this. You know what I mean? It's like you just let them do their thing.
Make lemonade, and I'm refreshing just like lemonade on a hot summer day.
What animal is fluffy?
Kitty!
What food is fluffy?
Cotton candy!
And what has both?
Money!
Hello, I'm the purple lilac cotton candy member of Ice Cream. I might surprise you with a few yum, but I hope to make you smile like fluffiness!
Yeah. Everyone, I'm Nemi. I'm the caramel orange member. I might be a little bit weird, but I hope you're gonna be able to encourage me. During concerts, don't forget to correctly drink and be careful with the people around you. Okay, guys?
Yes, Nemi.
Oh my God, Jesus! Have you heard about the new? This is the one I forgot to write down. Yesterday, I was like, someone recommended this to me. Have you seen this Turbulence meme that's been going around on TikTok?
No, what is it?
If you look up Turbulence on TikTok, it is like the top. Like, there are so many people using. The term, and it took me so long to figure out not to throw us into another one. This one.
Turbulence?
Yeah, so have you seen any of this guy?
A whole bunch of turbulence? Is this it?
Yeah, and this all happened like.
Let me do. You know what? I'm gonna just go for the world record. Duck shakes. Easy. I ain't gonna lie. It's gonna hurt. It's gonna sting. It might end up having a little bit of twang. But guess what? We're gonna push through this, and we're gonna do this. We're gonna do this. Easy. 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 There's nobody else on the internet that ever did the world record of thug shakes. And it's gonna.
Quiet! Enough! Enough! No.
It's gonna hurt, but guess what?
What is about to happen?
Every video, every bit of content comes with a sacrifice, especially when it comes to my content. But guess what? Like what I'm gonna push through it because that's what I do. That's what I do. And I ain't never ever gonna stop. Never ever gonna stop. All right, let's do it now.
That's also
we're gonna do 10 sets.
Which I thought that was someone else.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
I know what this is.
That's one set.
So there's a clip of him. I interviewed him, and he like rapped like a drill song and used And I know one of his friends is down there, like.
No, this is ass cheeks. Sorry, bro, that's his, ass cheeks, bro. What the fuck?
I actually thought it was his ass cheeks at first.
Yeah, that's his ass cheeks clapping. Or is this supposed to be your balls?
It's supposed to be your dick.
Is this supposed to be your dick hitting the fucking thighs?
I thought it was his ass cheek. It's supposed to be his cock going left and right.
I thought it was his ass cheeks clapping one by one,
that's
side
what
by
I
side.
I thought at first too, and I was like, oh,
that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Oh, that's awesome.
That's 2. We already did 20, and it already got some sting. But I ain't complaining because all my content comes with a sacrifice.
What is the sacrifice? Is he laughing now?
Matter of fact, I ain't gonna lie, the right side is low-key hurting just a little bit. So we're just gonna stick to the left side for right now. All right, I'm not gonna do too much. Let me do, you know.
Yeah, you gotta.
The sacrifice is his dignity. So, okay, it's his balls, I think. Yeah, no, he's just swinging it around. Got it. Okay, so this is...
Take a rap pause.
This dot on my body. She trying to harass me. Boy in the back. You cannot pass me. Run to the back and I feel like an athlete. She said, I said, I'm moving too flashy. Boy, you all talk. You tell him, shut up. Move like a plug on his block. What's up? She rocking D.O. Now she feeling stuck up. I mess up the beat like I'm messing her club up. Said that he's sliding. I tell that boy, run up. Chopper got pieces. I think I'm a drummer. Bro got a chop in the Glock. So he on the block for the duck when he come out the Hummer. Shorty a freak. I know she a Hummer. Hop in the trap. I'm counting numbers. She got the mouth. No, come on now. Easy.
Wow, that was pretty good.
And on that note,
these guys, they're doing unimaginable things.
Unimaginable things, these men.
Yeah, these men, they're doing glorious things.
Well, everyone, I hope you enjoyed my tea for the day. I work really hard to be this.
This was spectacular. Yeah. Spectacular. Yeah.
Maybe I should change my YouTube. Maybe that should be my gamer tag now.
That's your... this is Nick Talk.
All right. Well, hey, thanks for having me. I'm going to go play Legend of Zelda.
Uh-huh.
And,
All right. Shouts out to the Tacoma Wellness Center for keeping you hydrated.
Yeah, thanks. Shout out to Tacoma.
All right. Okay. That was Nick is not green, ladies and gentlemen.